And away we go for today's Sunday Funday shenanigans, which should be a little more interesting than normal because it's been a crazy weekend, man. It's when they pop out the when they bust out the double XP weekend, man, shit goes buck wild. It's double score, it's double XP, it's friggin' mutated events, and it's goddamn holiday scorched, and it's all kinds of chaos here with the scrub. I can't even call her a scrub anymore, man. Good lord, she's insane. So since last week, we changed the camp a little bit. I put a machine up, put my Collectron up, Santa presents, ho 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 on the side, with the light so people will see it, and it's unlocked. Yeah. So if anybody comes to my camp, that's my lost leader. You guys can get free presents from my Collectron. I also finally got the vintage water cooler plan. I was trying to burn caps. She had like 36,000, and I'm like, I gotta burn caps. So some guy was selling a vintage water cooler plan for an exorbitant price. It was like 25,000. I'm like, fuck it, I don't care. I need to burn caps. You've got it. I overpaid by 250%, but I don't give a shit. So now we're giving away free water. We're giving away free company tea. We're giving away free presents. I got my sign. It says resellers welcome. So if people want to come and clean me out and put it in their own machines and make more caps on it, you have my blessing. Take it and go with God. I don't care. But that's it. Right now there's a Moonshine Jamboree going. Yeah, 50 minutes ago. Yeah, we missed it. Fuck it. Loki, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Before we start, what I wanted to do really quick is Vlad, who popped in last week, was asking about one of my characters. Because one of the shots came up for the... Shit, hang on a second, guys. So fucking stupid, dude. I'm so tired of these... Camp attacks are just dumb, dude. They're just dumb. Black Wolf. Oh, you guys are just cruising? Okay, well, here... Let's not do that. There's a ghoul up here? What the fuck is this? What the hell are these guys doing here? Okay, are we all done now? Good lord. Oh, collect ballistic ammo. Look at that. I did one of the daily. I didn't even know the dailies. George, how's it going? Welcome to the stream. How is it going? Can I pick this up? Can you get rid of that shit, please? Thanks. Everyone's having an amazing and blessed day. Much love. Merry Christmas to you. Happy holidays and whatever phrasing you'd like to do to express your joy about the season. I'm okay with it. So back to what I was doing before. Vlad was asking about this guy here. Saying, what is his story? Is he Snipers as Wesley Snipes? No, this is my season 14 character. That was the end of his run. He was 96 when I deleted him. What he started looking like is this. That's what he looked like when we started the season, coming straight out of the ball. So that answers, in case, Vlad, you're looking, in case you're watching this for some reason, there's the answer to your question that I completely fucking missed last week because YouTube never showed it to me. Groucho and Glandry, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. How is it going today? So we have a Moonshine Jamboree going. It's over now. I missed it, so no big deal there. When we start, I'm going to go ahead and do this, knock this shit out at the beginning. Last week I talked about turning in, technical data, right? So I wanted to do that on the stream and show you guys what that's like. It took like 20 minutes and I'm not even going to fucking bother. But what I did basically is I just recorded it, yeah? This is what it looks like to turn these things in. This is what I did. You get on a fucking team, right? I changed to my crafting build, right? So I got Inspirational 3 running. I got 15 Intelligence, yeah? So we turn it in, to remove the technical data, go back to the box, grab another technical data, yeah? I want to show you this right here. She gets... Makes sense now. This is how much XP did I get for that? 3640, right? Yeah, 3640 for that one, let's right? But then my int buff just popped on my team. So I got 6 more in, right? So... When I turn it in this time, one technical data, yeah, gives me, got the bomber jacket, what the fuck, I don't care about that, and I got 3797, yeah, 3797, so I was getting literally anywhere between 3600, 3640, and 3797 per technical data, okay. She went from 224 to 242 in about 20 minutes. Yeah. I was drowning in purified water and Radaway because they give you a lot of that. But I also got, she was also able to secure Night Captain and Night Paint, and she worked her way to Night Sergeant. What I generally do when I get those, when I start doing this, is I'll get three of the plans, right? Three of each rank. I'll learn one so I can start getting the next one, right? So I got three Night Paints, three Night Captain Paints, and then I started working on the Night Sergeant Paint, yeah? Because she was ranking up her thing. And that means, so I've got two of each to sell, yeah? The Metalhead subscriber count. Pete Kraft, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. I'm a hidden treasure, call it selfish, don't blow it too big time. Oh, dude, there is no danger of me blowing up big time. I am not the type of streamer who is going to attract a generalized audience, P-Craft. Not going to happen, dude. I don't do face cam. I don't do all the things that YouTubers are expected to do. Yeah, I just have a good time, hang out, do shit on the thing, fuck around in the game, and just shoot the shit and answer questions if you have any questions that I can actually answer about the game, which is what I enjoy doing. So, yeah. Metalhead, yeah, another group. Well, either way, man. I mean, it works both ways, right? We can rock and roll. Visiting home? All right, you're visiting home. Excellent. Little Mans is doing good. I had a very good friend come over last night. I haven't seen him in like 10 months. And we haven't hung out in like 10 months. So he came over last night, and he did not know about Mr. Beans. So but he likes tattoos, so I showed him my new tattoo, and he's like, oh, Jesus, dude. I'm like, yeah. So we had a nice discussion about that. He had lost his, he had an Adobe that he lost a year before, and I hadn't had a chance to talk to him about it yet. So I'm like, I need to talk to you. I need to pick your brain about this, dude, because I'm losing my fucking mind. And he's like, no, you're normal. It's normal. This is what happens. He's like, I just needed to talk to someone who understands, you know, because it's like, it's hard to express the difficulty of dealing with it for somebody who doesn't have a long-term animal companion, you know, in a specific situation. I mean, it sounds cheesy and shit, but it's just, it's like, I don't know. But it was good. All the building videos. That's good, dude. That's what we're here for. That's what we're here for. Hopefully, if they ever release the Fallout 4 update patch, I will download that son of a bitch, and we'll jump back in and see what it looks like, maybe. Slacker, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. So we hung out and played some Valheim. That was fun, and just hung out and shot the shit. And it was very satisfying, gratifying. Yeah, it's like, okay, I got that off my chest. Oh my god. And he met Little Mans, and Little Mans does not like new people. Holy fuck, boy, he was just not having it. But you know, I told him the story about the adoption there and this and that and the other thing, and he's like, oh my god, dude, you're so awesome for doing this cat. I'm like, you know what? The thing is, dude, he's a cat, you know? I'm not adopting like a golden retriever, yeah? I'm not adopting a lab. They don't need to go splashing into the surf to pick up that duck I just hit with a shotgun, yeah? A cat is mobile furniture, dude. He doesn't really need his legs to do his job of companionship. I mean, it would be nice if he could, you know, use a litter box normally and do whatever he wanted to. But, you know, it's fine. He does good. And I told him, don't feel sorry for him. He does fine. So he's like, okay. I'm like, no, he totally does, man. Not saying the typical YouTube garbage. Yeah, well, I'm not a YouTuber, P-Craft. I don't want to make a job out of this. I don't want to be a brand or a personality. I just want to hang out with cool people and play games and shoot the shit and talk strategies and try and figure out how to do cool shit. You know, it's like I don't need to make a career out of this shit. I don't think I would hate it if I did, because you know, it's only fun if it's a hobby, right? If it turns into a job, I'm like, well, shit, now I gotta punch in and fucking, you know, hit my metrics and get my I'm like, I ain't got time for that shit, man. It's just not, that's not interesting to me. It would be a lot less fun, I think. Marty, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Tell bad jokes, torment Dagwood leaves from Heights. Yeah, man. Well, we got, you know, we got the crew and the inside jokes and shit, so it's like we got our own little thing going. Speaking of, I gotta join a team here. Hang on a second. Let me get through with my run here, yeah. And happy to anybody I missed. I'm trying to see what's going on here with the and happy holidays to you too. Good to see you. Say hi to VG for me. And we'll keep going with this. See if we can't, I'm gonna be tormented on Christmas. Don't worry, I don't have fall damage on this character, dude. You're fine. I can't jump off stuff on this character. Oh, I mean, I can, but she'll die, so I'm not doing it. It ain't like Faith, who had 250% fall damage pieces. I can just jump off the monorail elevator with no problems. It's like, I just like, and go, ooh, and I'm done. Yeah, there won't be no, there will be no jumping. It isn't Christmas yet. It is in some parts of the world, Groucho. Yeah. The people who are living in the future are already doing their Christmas things, but we're not, and it's fine. We can do this in weathered. Man, fuck this. She has not gotten lucky with the things. I mean, I did find a green one. Yeah, I did find a green one and a couple of browns. Put them in the machine for super cheap. Somebody bought the green one yesterday for like $7.50. And then I found a, I got a quad faster fire rate minigun from an eviction notice, and I'm like, you know what, someone's gonna want this thing, but it's a two-star, it's not that good of a weapon, but it's a fun weapon to have around. So I dumped it in there for $7.50. Somebody bought it in like 15 minutes, and I'm like, well, I guess I did price it right, eh? But that's what we're doing, just running around doing random shit. Red tactical, sure. Apparently headlamps are broken on power armor right now, so you can't even install those things, but I still picked them up because that's 10 fucking caps. I have not gotten a lot of sales this weekend, but I'm not surprised by that because people are spending their caps on wrapping paper for the holiday gifts. I have not really done a lot of holiday gift, you know what, let's just go knock that out. This game changed my issues with finding out this is online and multiplayer. That's the thing. Yeah, I mean, it is online and multiplayer, but it's not your typical online multiplayer game, right? It's, you can play it solo just fine. There's no requirement that you play with other... I mean, God damn it. Speaking of, let me get on a team here. Inspirational Rejuvenated Ricochet. Okay, good. No one else is running Inspirational. But see, I love being on teams, man. I tell you what. I really, really... And Dag, welcome to the stream. If I did not welcome you, I was just tormenting you, but I did not welcome you. I had really, really... You're not unhappy with your Bethesda early Christmas gifts. Yeah, she, this character here, I've been just accumulating the gifts. I haven't even opened them on her yet. There's apparently new ones. When I came back to my camp one time, there was a plastiform candle plant in a bag by my machine. So I'm guessing someone like grabbed the gifts out of the bot, opened them up, and maybe found a duplicate, and they just dropped it for me, which is kind of nice. A lot of people lock their Sanitrons. I do not. I'm like, you know what? It's Christmas, dude. You want presents? Fucking take them, dude. I am okay with this 100% of the time. Who's that? Was that it? Was that the squatter? Oh, shit. I gotta fix that chainsaw. Remove squatters. Where is he? Oh, fuck. He's right next to me. Whoops. Whoops.
Nice work. Sensors indicate the problem squatters have been removed. Check in with me from time to time.
I may have additional assignments for you to carry out. Yeah. He thought more so like wanting to kill people for no reason. Yeah, the thing is they added, look at that. 4,000 XP for that. Jesus Christ. They added a pacifist mode way back in the day, and, Mr. Funky's got some shit. Let's go see what he's got. So once they turned pacifist mode on, it wasn't all PvP all the time. It got a lot more pleasant, more polite, yeah? Because it's like most Fallout fans don't really give a shit about PvP. They just want to play the post-apocalyptic shit with their friends, yeah? So that's what this game eventually turned into, and that is good, yeah? That is, that makes it a lot more pleasant, right? Those in there. All right. You know what? Let's put away. But yeah, I haven't got a lot of shoppers this weekend because, you know, everybody's buying, you know, gift wrap with their money. So sales have been slow, but that's okay. That's okay. I've got 3 pounds of, Jesus Christ, I need to go sell shit. Let's go check this guy's camp first, though. Let's go check this guy's camp, see what we got here. He's right here. And this weekend has been a little bit crazy, man. I had my Friday visit, and then my friend came over yesterday, and then today later on, I'm going to be doing Christmas Eve dinner with my neighbors, who are awesome. And then tomorrow, I have going to, I've been invited to a brunch. So I'm just like, this is a crazy weekend for me. That's, I'm going to be sleeping for like a week with all this social interaction. I don't know what the fuck to do about all that. Okay, what have we got here? Anti-armor chainsaw? Oh, man. If that thing was weight, we would be totally fucking doing it. Nothing in there. You got anything in here I want? No. Brain bombs. You're selling brain bombs for 30? That's pretty nice of you, dude. You're selling adhesive? You are. For 10. 10. I'm profiteering on adhesive, but I'm only selling it for 3. So, yeah, whatever. Yeah, let's go fix my shit. Were you a good boy this year? Why did you do those things? Yeah, your Santa Collectron gives you shit, right? You're like, look, I'm never a good boy. Oh, I gotta turn to my script, too. Fuck, I forgot about that. What have we got here? Culper slurry. I'm not dealing with that. What have we got for fucking claim a workshop? Homie, I am not claiming a fucking workshop. That is not going to happen. Build turrets or traps in a workshop or camp in free camps. 800. I got an epic, huh? Nice. All right, let's clean all this shit out of this box. Let me get rid of some of this crap. I mean, I'm just drowning in shit here. I just got to get rid of this stuff. I forgot about it for like the last 3 days, and I've got all this extra stuff in here. No, wait a minute. I'm going to keep that. Yeah, I'm going to keep that one. Get rid of that one. Get rid of this one. Get rid of that one. Get rid of that one. Still not getting very lucky on her unyielding. I found a, I mean, her unyielding, her overeaters. I found a couple pieces in vendors that was pretty good, so I got one of those. But let's just start dropping shit in this box. Screw this. Back or that and this and that and this and that. 3288. Okay, good. We're gonna get rid of all this stuff. Hooray! Go to that, go to that, go to that. Alright, let's fix our fucking guns. Camp, and then we switch this to rejuvenation, inspirational. 3, because I want to make sure these guys don't... Why not claim a workshop? I don't... You don't have to defend it. That's true, I don't have to defend it. But the thing is, I don't like PvP, Marty, at all. Even the potential for PvP. And on a claim the workshop event day, the odds are much higher that someone's going to come and fuck with me. And I just don't want to deal with it. I got the reroll. I'm just going to use it. I don't know, man. I just really hate PvP. Just even the thought of it, I hate it. I don't want to deal with it. So I would just as soon avoid that. Now, with that said, if there is a, hang on a second here. If there is a weekly that has claim 3, then I will do those. Yeah? I'll just go to Dolly Sods, claim it, hop, claim it, hop, claim it, hop, and I'm gone. I'm like, that's it. It's fine. So that one's not so bad. But since I'm on teams, I don't like just randomly hopping servers. Yeah? So, you know, 6-1 half dozen of them there. I hate PvP, dude. I hate it. And people go, oh, that's because you suck at it. I'm all, yeah, I do suck at it, dude. But my sucking at it is not why I don't like it, okay? That's just one more reason to not want to participate in it, okay? It's not the primary driver. It simply is what it is. So get rid of those, get rid of that. And then in here, we'll get rid of the daddy-o. That doesn't sell for shit. Get rid of those. Radex. How come I have 36 of these, dude? That's stupid. And then sell 27 of those. And then get rid of those. I hate those. And then 24 of these. Right. Okay. Cool. Now we're rolling. And we drop off all the ammo I don't want. But yeah, I mean, in theory, I don't mind the claiming the workshop part. It's just, I just hate PvP. I just hate it. And I don't want to participate in it anyway. So what I end up doing is I hide somewhere when I take the workshop. We suck at it as we don't enjoy it. There's no reason to get better at it. Well, so technically speaking, that's kind of a thing. The me not liking PvP is sort of a recent thing. It's sort of the dislike for PvP went hand in hand with my skill dropping. Okay. because I've been gaming a long time, dude. Okay, a long time. And I used to love playing games like Doom and Quake online with people. And I was, okay, I'm not going to be the, oh yeah, I'm not going to be the Al Bundy, I scored 4 touchdowns on a high school football game. I'm just going to tell you this. My eyesight and my hand-eye coordination didn't used to be this shitty, okay? I used to be really fucking good at PvP. Quake and Doom, yeah? Unreal Tournament. Dude, when they saw my fucking name, dude, they gunned for me, dude. I was good. I was really, really good. I couldn't place first in tournaments, but I was always top 3, man. I was a fucking demon, dude. So the worst part of being old is I remember how good I used to be, and now I know I'm not at all, and I'm just like, oh my god, this is terrible. I mean, fucking skills are blah blah. Because I have a frame of reference for how shitty I am now, right? Because I used to be good. I used to be kind of cool, man. So yeah, that was okay, here it is. That flat spot we saw last week up by that flat spot I went looking for up by Point Pleasant, that camp you just saw was the one that was built there. Yeah. That made me think, oh, this is a great place to build a camp. And when I get done with this, I'll show you. I'll go to the photo gallery and show you that camp. So when Easy comes in later, he can look at it and go, oh my god, that camp is fucking awesome. I go, this is awesome, dude. I will never be able to replicate that shit. Let's close the guy's door. I don't like that. Okay, where are your machines, dude? Are they outside? A lot of people put them outside. That's the fun part about trying to find people's machines, is figuring out their logic for building a camp. Okay, is it locked? It's open. Look at that. And no, I did not take anything from it. And it's open here, too. Look at you. You're a pimp, dude. You are a good player. You are a good player and a good teammate. Who is camps this? Krunk Casper 49. Homie, you are a champ. Everything's unlocked, including the arm code machine. Even I don't unlock the arm code machine, man. Because I'm like, bitch, it took me way too fucking long to get that thing, and I need the ammo really bad because I'm a shitty shot. You know? But yeah, it's all open, man. His vendors, is it, if I can find his, oh, here it is. I've walked right past it twice. I don't recognize the machine, yeah? What you got in here, homie? Anything I want? Barbed wire fences, blue. Look at the prices! Okay, Krunk Casper's a... Is it Krunk Casper's a word? Krunk Casper 49. This is a player. I like you, dude. I don't even know you, but I like you. Everything's nice and 25, man. Barbed wire fences for 25, Blue Ridge Rug. If I was keeping this character, I would totally snap those up, man. This guy's really fucking cool. 38,000 miscellaneous? What the hell is even happening? If you want a game that has all PvP, play Sea of Thieves. But it turns out, Glantry, they're making safe servers now. It's coming out fairly soon. Yeah? Coming out fairly soon. It's basically, you can only advance so far reputation-wise. You can't buy everything, you can't do everything. But they're going to introduce a non-PvP mode, and I may be playing that. Because I did like Sea of Thieves. I like running around digging up treasure and looking at maps and shit. It was fun. I just didn't like getting ganked every fucking time I went anywhere near a port. I was just like, you got old, man. But not my ammo. Yeah, dude, I'm a shitty shot slacker. I need all the ammo I can get, man. So, but yeah, I enjoyed Sea of Thieves, dude. I really loved it. Right until I ran into another player, it was really fucking fun. But as soon as I did, I'm like, nope, I'm not interested in this, dude. I don't fucking care. I, you know. Okay, we need to make, what, glowing fungus? Turrets or traps? Okay, let me do that really quick. If I can build a trap, I can do that in build mode, no problem. But yeah, you can take everything you want. But that's the thing, Slacker, right? All that other stuff, I can get as long as I have ammo. Right? But if I don't have ammo, I can't get any of that stuff. Let me take this shit out of here just to clear it out so that more presence can spawn in there. Okay, so let's do this. Go into build mode. Turrets and traps. Let's just go. Let's go cheesy and easy and just build these fucking things right here. I don't want vertical movement. I want object rotation. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Do I got to build 10? 6? I had to build 6? Okay, that's weird, but that's a strange quantity, but I'll take it. That's 800 points. No, you'll notice I'm not running score boosters because the score boosters only the score booster applies to both dailies and weeklies, and I much prefer to get the score boost on the weeklies. So I run it, I do it like Tuesday afternoon, so I can get all the dailies and Tuesday and Wednesday and all the weeklies get the boost, yeah? get sniped by the pirates. Exactly, Glenn. It's just sometimes it's fun to get the little treasure maps and talk to the little dudes in port and get locations of shit and go out and fight skeletons and dig shit up. It's just fun. I don't need the PvP experience, dude. I don't need that shit. Okay, so what else we got to do? Kill a Mirelurk. Sell glowing fungus soup. Okay, well, I can do that later. Let's go kill some Mirelurks. People always go to the marsh up there where the queen is to do this. You can go to Vault 94, too. Vault 94 is a really quick and easy way to knock out Mirelurk challenges because there's a ton of them fuckers in there. And nobody ever goes to 94. But when I have to kill just four or five, I just go to the fucking... I just go to the Lake Reynolds over here. Because there's four of them out here. Load-bearing, man... Aviator Raider, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Happy holidays. Good to see you. How's it going? We got fucking load-bearing, man. We couldn't get Moonshine Jamboree, could we? No. We gotta get fucking load-bearing. Was it? It's fucking resilient, too, isn't it? Freezing Touch. Yeah. Not my favorite. But fuck it. We'll do it. I don't even give a shit about mutated party packs anymore. Now they got the plans I want. Just not, okay, there's a bug with him. Look at that. He's, Hey, buddy. Come on, look out. Time to die, homie. Alright, let's do this. Oh, she got a hat, too. I didn't use a hat with her for a long time. But, where's the other one? Here you are. What's up, buddy? There's three. There's four. Also, this is... when you come out here, if you ever have to kill a Mirelurk Hunter for a challenge, there's always a hunter in Lake Reynolds. There's always one out here. So if you got to take a picture of one, or okay, you know what? If you're fucking bailing, so am I. I'm out. Fucking, I'm hopping servers, dude. To hell with it. I'll get bonded on another goddamn team. Let's see if we can get a good one. Crunk Casper left the team, and so did I. He's hopping servers just like me because load bearing sucks. Freezing Touch, not my favorite. And we're gonna go. Jameson, your coffee and watching me. Everything is good. Yeah, I got my caffeine. I had some leftover pizza, so that was my breakfast. Heart of the Swamp, active camouflage. Fuck that. I ain't doing that shit. Nope. We're out. Time to have servers again. Woo! See if we can get a good one. Give me some guided meditation. Give me guided meditation with active camouflage. Give me that one. Give me. There it is. That's the camp. Remind me after the event. I will show you. I will leave this up on the screen longer. Although this is up there pretty long. But this is that flat spot we were looking at, right? Look at that camp. Fucking looks nice, man. I don't know the person's name, though. I didn't write it down. I know it's a really nice camp, huh? I'm a swarm of suitors again? Man, fuck you with a swarm of suitors bullshit. We're out. Sorry, man. I want a long one. That's what she said. I want to get a guided meditation giving a fucking uranium fever. Give me a one violent night. Oh, I did a one violent night the other day. Oh, my God. I was confusing the shit out of the people who were doing it. Because I was on an instrument like I do, right? I was on an instrument like I do. Moonshine Jamboree and it's resilient? Yeah, fuck it. Let's do it. Let's do it. Let's fucking do it. Hopefully they didn't start it yet. And let's do this. Let's go fucking crazy. True, how's it going? Welcome to the stream. Happy holidays to you, sir. Light the fire. Oh, fuck, dude, you're starting it now? There's no casual teams here? Shit. Come on, come on, come on, let me out of this. 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 Come on, I gotta switch cards, dude. Hurry up, hurry up. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Fuck this. Am I topped up? You're top. With that sizable salamander venom. Yeah, I know. They started too early, Ace. I get it, dude. Events? Shit. Okay. So now we're gonna do some chainsaw action. What's up, buddy? How you doing, man? Oh yeah, look at that shit. Chew him up, buddy. Oh yeah, come on. Come on, shoot him, dude. Do some damage. I don't wanna wear out my chainsaw on this shit. Yeah, this is how we get it done. Woohoo! Oh shit, I'm out of AP already. Not good. Are you guys gonna shoot these motherfuckers or what, man? I can't do all the work of my chainsaw. Thank you! Get some guns going! Let's do it, man! Let's do this shit, come on! Whee! I finally got my second point in, Funky Duds, so I can, I can sit here in the toxic stink and not have to worry about dying. Sure do hate that. Come on, guys, start shooting, man. Whee! Look at her covered with guck and blood and shit. It's like, yeah, dude. Oh, look, we leveled. Whee! Come on, boys. Boy, it got busy really fast here. This is only wave one, dude. Look at this shit. Yeah, guys, come on, let's do some shooting. Throw some grenades. I'm okay with grenades now. Field still? Are you over there? Okay, he's over there. Sorry, we're closed. Bloody be- Opsu, how you doing? Welcome to the stream, and thank you very much, and merry happy holidays. Thank you for sticking with the little man. Well, yeah, most people would abandon him. I know, at least six people did. Did I tell you that story? Were you here for the story? When I adopted him, when I went down to do him, right, I was looking at the cats. And I was looking for a social cat, right? One that would key on me and want to hang out with me, right? So when I saw him in his little crate, he reached out through the cage and he was like, dude, Attica, get me the fuck out of here. So I was like, all right. So I picked him up. Yeah, I looked at him. I'm like, okay, I don't really like black cats. I didn't really want a young cat, but he had the right attitude, yeah? So I was like, okay. So at the vet, because it was the animal shelter, right, where they euthanize them. It was at the public shelter. And they have a system, right, where they give all the animals, they give all the critters a name, a tag, a number. And you take the number on this little tear strip on this piece of paper, yeah. And what you do is when you're interested in adopting, you would take the little strip, you tear the strip off the little info card, take it to the coordinator or whatever. They give you the breakdown of his medical history and anything they know about him and shit, whatever. Well, he didn't have any strips left on his card. Noel, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. He didn't have any tear strips left, which means at least six people were interested in him, tore the strip off, went to the coordinator, found out his legs didn't work, and left him there. And I was like, yeah, that's not going to happen. That's not acceptable. So I was like, you're coming home with me. I don't know how to take care of a cat with this problem. I'm more used to older cats with kidney and thyroid and eye problems and shit. But I'm like, you know what, we'll figure it out. So when I realized that at least six people had just left him there, I'm like, nah, you're coming home with me, man. We'll figure it out. Because he's a cat. He doesn't really need his legs to do his job, which is to be a companion, right? And, I have a one-story house, which is helpful. He didn't have to climb stairs, so that's good. I couldn't leave him there. And he has been an absolutely wonderful companion. He knows how to do his job. He's skittish as hell. You know, he's still getting used to things. He doesn't like new stuff very much. Like I tell people, he's a normal cat, but he's not a regular cat. Okay? He's my boy. And if he gets better, all that means I'll have to wipe his ass less, and I'll probably have to stop cleaning shit up off the floor. But the rest of the time, he's fine, man. Like right now, he's looking out the back window and yelling at squirrels. I'm like, that's what a cat does. Don't need legs for that. I mean, I would be a lot happier if he could use his legs. Maybe someday he will. But, he's a good boy. He is a good companion. Whee. She's doing really good on AP here. Oh, it's wave three already? Wow. Maybe I should, let's go ahead and do this real quick. Let's get some guts in the tub here. Yeah. Da-da-da-da. Whee! This is actually so much fucking fun. And I'm not even built for melee, man. Yeah? Whee! So much fun, dude. This is so stupid.
Just enough venom to make a batch!
still can't pet him yet, becomes insistent. Yeah, I mean, they're cats, dude. They have their own their way of doing things, right? Because you gotta remember, they haven't been domesticated for very long, right? They're not, oh shit, I'm gonna die, dude. Gotta pay attention to my health here, huh? Let's do that. Okay, let's get rid of the trash here. Whee! Even a low skills gamer like me can do this. Watch his health just evaporate. Yeah? Yeah, it gets a little meaty in here. Talk about getting the meat sweats, huh? Jeez. Yeah, baby boy. Are you okay? Are you done? You're okay. Sorry, Bubble, we're closed. Okay, let's do this real quick. Let's get this last one in here.
Standing work, moonshiners!
I assume the balancing of 76 is better than 4? Yes and no. I mean, 76 is more of a MMO in that it has more and less, clearly more effective and less effective builds. But since it's a multiplayer game, unlike Fallout 4, you're not required to solo everything. Yeah. So like right now, I mean, I'm running a fucking chainsaw. I'm not even a melee build, dude, but I'm doing just fine here because everybody else around is doing bringing the pain. Yeah. And there's metas, you know, the bloodied and the unyielding builds and the this, the that, and the commandos and the heavies. There's, you know, optimal builds for this, that, and the other thing. But you can have a great time with an off meta, just, you know. You just won't be able to solo everything like the heavy hitters can. But since it's a multiplayer game, you don't got to worry about that, right? And that's really the key. Oh, you're in here now? Okay, well, shit, I'll stay in here then. If you're gonna rock the inside of the thing, we'll do that. Come on. Man, we're gonna do this easily, man. But yeah, it is. I mean, it's the thing about it. The thing about it that differs the most, Aviator from Fallout 4, is the dynamic of perks aren't permanent and they're not designed to be. That is something that will take you some getting used to. Yeah, because you have to optimize in order to be effective. You can't half-ass a build, right? Your gear matters, but not nearly as much as your perks do. And, like they say, with the right build, you can get away with a wet noodle. You can kill shit with a wet noodle. With the wrong build, you could have a god roll meta and still not do shit. So, like I said, it takes some getting used to. It definitely takes some getting used to if you're used to Fallout 4's, buy a perk forever. Are you saying it's easier? Oh, yeah, dude. Oh, god, yes. Oh, it's a lot easier. Because it's a fixed difficulty. Yeah. So it's got to be approachable and playable by anybody, right? That said, you know, once you get your shit going, you can bring the pain, but it's a learning experience. But yeah, no, dude, if a low skills gamer like me, look at me here, dude. We've just manhandled this fucking event, yeah? And I'm not even a melee build, dude. I have no perks for this chainsaw other than makeshift warrior so it doesn't disintegrate in my hands when I use it, yeah? Because I just fixed this thing, right? And it's already, I already used a full durability bar plus a little bit. I mean, it's crazy, right? And I leveled, what, 3 times there? I don't even know, dude. I wasn't even paying attention. But yeah, stupid, right? But it's fucking fun, man. It's fucking fun. How much money do I got? 22,000? Yeah, that's fine. Scrap junk at every workbench. Yeah, every workbench, you can scrap everything everywhere. flippity floppity floop. Let's see how long it takes it to figure out. Is it going to pop it out? Normally it will pop it out. Shake, rattle, and roll. Shake, rattle, and roll. Okay, you done now? Cool. He's getting on that car. He's digging. He's like he's digging for fucking troubles and shit or something, man. I don't even know what. Yeah, we got some good. We got some legendaries there, I think. I don't really care. See, because where we really get the bonus here, yeah? Do I even have lunchbox running? I do. Oh, shit. Hurry up. 75% more XP. This is where you cash in, man, because you get free XP for cooking shit, yeah? So here, let's do this. All food, right? Cook that. Cook the fog crawler meat. Gold for slurry, right? 224. Watch how much XP I get for this. 4,000, dude. I think that's the max you can get. So fucking stupid, dude. Whee! Oh, wait. Did she hit? Yeah, she hit 250. Yay! Congratulations, 250! Congratulations, she hit 250, dude. So, she was born on November 25th. Today is December 24th. That means she has been alive for a month. Yeah, just about a month. 30 days. In 30 days, I got 250 levels, which means she gets, which means she's been getting, on average, 8 levels a day. Every day. Just from playing. Not even doing anything, just from playing. Which is insane to me, man. It's fucking insane. Alright, let's go turn in our legendaries here. Da-dee-dee. Did I get a mutated pack? I might have. Uh-oh. Oh, no. Oh, no. You don't get to go free. There's something visceral about that, man. Where did he go? Oh, here he is. Wonder glue. Nice. Okay, she's on the level, and then some. Exactly. XP for cooking. Yeah, XP for cooking, XP for crafting, XP for building, XP, XP, XP. I mean, at a certain point for some players, late game is XP. That's basically what you do, is you grind XP. And some of the levels I've seen are high, very high. Oh, they leave something behind for me? Any presents? It's spoiled meat. I don't need spoiled meat. What do we get? Just this shit, huh? Nothing much, but I don't really care. Anything in here? Plastic plate. I will absolutely take that. And off we go. Okay, and in here we're at 1047. Oh, somebody must have bought some shit. People were shopping. Yay. Yay. Okay, Wallace, buy my crap. Just get rid of all this shit here. Get rid of that. Get rid of this and that and these. And those. Then in here, get rid of that. Those. I don't use Rad-X, and I don't use Radaway, so off it goes. 19 diluted stim packs? Yeah, get rid of those fuckers, because it uses those first, man. I get bushwhacked, and I'm like, fuck, I'm dying. Why can't I'm not healing? Because I'm using diluted stim packs instead of fucking full-strength ones. It's like, no! Hollow? Yeah, put that in there. And then are there any... Yeah, one of those. Okay. All right. Easy, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Hey, good timing. I just got to the point where I remembered to do something. So last week we had that flat spot over by Point Pleasant that I was searching for, with the trees, that little elevated plateau. The reason I remembered that and I wanted to show you that is because somebody built a camp there that looked like this. They built this camp in that spot. I mean, you can see the trees, right, surrounding it. But this camp looks really fucking good, right? And since it's flat, you can put the tent like they have over there on the left where they have their vending machines, right? You can put tents down, and they don't look stupid. They don't float, you know? But, I mean, this is cute, right? You got the trailer on the right. You got a tiny little house on the middle. And then you got the gazebo with the little hot tub on the left. It's cute as fuck, yeah? It's cute as fuck. And happy holidays to you, Easy. But that's what this camp up by Point Pleasant look like. My only regret is that I don't have the person's name who made this. normally when I take a screenshot, I will write down their gamer tag. And I did not write their gamer tag. But this is cute as hell, right? It's busy, but it's still kind of open. They got the little planners. They got random stuff scattered around, but it actually looks kind of good. It's just a little town, a little whatever. I don't know. Oh, and then, of course, I found another can the other day. Someone really likes Santa. Holy Jesus, someone likes Christmas. This was up in the Savage Divide. I don't remember where, but I mean, this is a little excessive. All right, so I got it, right? Did I get another mutated party pack? Yeah, I got another mutated party pack. I got 7 of them now. Holy Christmas, I know, right? They just went fucking apeshit, man. And I'm just like, you go on with your bad self, man. I guess somebody would have done, I guess somebody had done, yeah, the cars are all blown up. They did a little thing recently. Do I want to do Uranium Fever? Let me do my tradition. I'll go run the asylum here really quick, and then we'll hop servers. Because I don't like being on events teams, because you don't get as much XP as you do for being on casuals. But she hit 250, so hooray, level 250. I'm on like rank 71 on the scoreboard. I'm thinking, man, gotta get her to 300 by the time I fucking log off for this season? Can I get 300 levels and 100 ranks? I don't know, but we're gonna find out. See if any of my teammates are mutated. Here's my test to see if we're mutated. Salt and pepper? No. You found a pink and yellow hat? What, from the presents? Yeah, I haven't opened my presents. Maybe we'll do that on the stream with her, because I haven't bothered with them. You know, I'm gonna wait till after the end of the holiday Scorched event. It runs like 2 weeks, right? It runs through January, and I'm just not really interested in them because, I mean, I'm deleting her. So nurse hats. Oh yeah, no, the hats are static. The hats will always be in the same spots. Yeah, the hats aren't random. That's why they're valueless. Like the pink hat, I know where the pink hat is. I know where the red hat is. The blue hat is up on the second floor. Oh, look. Uh-oh, what's this? I don't need that. But like the pink hat, yeah, it's over here. You get the pink hat over here, right? The pink hat is in this room, and it's right there. Yeah, it's always there. And then there's a forest hat in the laundry room right here. Yeah. And then the red one's on the second floor. But it's in this whole place, easy. Those three spots on the beds and the shower, that's literally the only random spawns. Every other spawn is fixed. I mean, there's a random spawn in supply room where there's a I forget where it is. Where there's some lockers and there's a uniform that spawns behind the There's a uniform that spawns behind the lockers, but it can only be dirty weathered or white. It's not one of the special ones. The special ones only spawn in those specific spots. Oh, where the hell are you going? I spend way too much time in the fucking asylum. Let's just put it that way, yeah. But if you cover it, you'll the spawns, and there's a blue hat. The blue one's on the third. The blue one's on the third floor. Third floor. Which floor is the one where they're behind the, where there's that extra area behind the. Is it on this side? I know the location. I can see it in my head, but I don't remember where it is in the thing. Yeah, it's on the third floor, behind the Wendigo. It's down here. There's a section on the second floor. Is it down here? Where you go? Motherfucker. Oh, wait. Is it back there? God damn it, I can never remember where the fuck it is. But it's the area where it's collapsed and... No, this ain't it. because this... Oh, this ain't the switch side. Duh, I'm on the wrong fucking side. It's on the switch side. It's underneath... It's on the second floor underneath the switch. And the blue... Let me do this here real fast. I'm not going to loot. We're just going to get through this. Sneaking is a habit, of course. And you. And you. Right. Okay, let's get that shit out of the way. Cool. The red hat is in here. Ooh, a legendary. Nice. The red hat... No, it's not here. It's upstairs. And no, didn't get it. Okay, it's fine. Where are we going here? Let's do this shit. Are you over here, big boy? There we are. Yeah. Okay. Alright. So the red hat is on the second floor in the first office up the stairs, which is right here. Right? It's on the desk. Red hat's there. Right? Then, if you go to the third floor, then down here, there's another section down here I always forget about. But there's only like five ghouls down there. There's really not much there. But where we're going... where are the ghouls? I gotta kill you guys. And then you, and you. And then on the left. Are you in there? No, you're over here, right? Yeah, there you are. Okay. Murder his dumbass. Get all the loots. Then we go here to the second floor. But back there on the second floor is a section where there's a bunch of offices that are collapsed. And there's a side room with a Nuka-Cola machine and a plastic fork near the... let's see if we get some technical data here in the beginning. No, we got some gold though. Gold is nice. So you're cruising through here, a ton of shitload of ghouls here, probably a Wendigo today too, huh? Or is it a glowing? No, it's a Wendigo. And then down here we have you. And then through the hole in the floor we have you. And then, anybody wandering around? I see caution. There should be two more downstairs. Oh, no, you made upstairs. Good for you, dude. Okay. May have done this a few times. Yeah, may have done this a few times. Still one more running around somewhere. I hear him. He's downstairs. Come on, man. You in a side room? Did you get lost? Bad time to get lost, friend. Okay. Get rid of your dumbass. And then down here, on this first floor, don't forget the industrial grade Aprexo. There's a blue hat here on this desk. Yeah. But yeah, there's one of each color all throughout the place. This is a great place for scrap. Oh, dude, this is a great place for aluminum. This is a great place for fucking acid. It's a great place for lead. But yeah, aluminum, dude. If you need aluminum, this place is full of trays. Oh my fucking god. It is so full of trays. This is why when I'm a lobby, right, when I start a new game, if Line in the Sand pops, I'm there. I get a free ride to the fucking asylum, looting ahoy. Yeah? 130 technical data? I did 82 myself the other day. The key is, yeah, I got... Well, I went over at the beginning of the stream. I showed you guys what it looked like going back and forth to Scribe Valdez. Yeah. But she went from 234 to 242 the other day in about 20 minutes. Yeah. And I did, I got the Science Scribe outfit, the Engineer's outfit, a bunch of bomber jackets, a bunch of T60 paint. I'm selling those for 1,000 a piece. I'm going to see if anybody will nibble on those. I think they will. Because a lot of people don't know where those come from, you know. They don't turn in the technical data. Ooh, what have we got? Any casual teams? And it's full, but this one isn't. What's up, Iktomi64 and Quispy Sprite? How you guys doing today? Hope you enjoy the XP, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, do that. Open the door. Always a good sign when the door is closed. That means the inside is reset and nobody's been here since it did. Doesn't mean anything. We're mutated. Good. No, not there. All right, let's go check for our... Let's go. Oh, let's stay on the... See? That's why I don't PvP, man. I can't even fucking stay on the stairs, dude. Okay, little man's drinking some water. Good. He's a little thirsty cat. Oh, it turns out that Mr. Little Man's is, in fact, he's a water cat. Mr. Beans is a water cat, too. But they're different kinds. We get the rad shields. We'll do that after this. Give me 5 minutes to clean this out and check this. Brown! Look at that! There's a brown one. I'm not even picking it up. And nothing there. Okay, that's fine. You get rad shields by doing a quest. You craft them. You learn the recipe from doing the Ella Ames research. If you go, once you're doing the Free State stuff, you do, once you do the Free State stuff, you'll go to Ella Ames's bunker to get a heating coil for Abby. When you're there, if you look at her terminal, she has notes on rad shield research, right? Where she was experimenting on how to make the shit. And like everything else in this game, you complete a dead person's pet project and you learn how to make rad shield. Rad shield requires strangler blooms. It requires antiseptic and purified water. That's its formula. It does get boosted from the chemist perk, so you can make two instead of one. And it does proc with super duper. And we've got sturdy robot torso. I'll take it. Contrary to popular belief, once you've done the quest, right, you won't see strangler blooms until you do the quest, right? There's like a flag on your character that enables it to spawn. Oh, there he goes. He has a little orange mouse. I put it on top of his scratching post. He is very territorial about his scratching post. He's like, if anything's on there, I'm tearing it off and killing it. I'm like, yeah, you do that. So you do that, and you've got. So what you do is you go to Ella Ames' bunker, yeah, and you get the notes, and she says, "I'm gonna go out, take my shotgun, and I'm gonna go do whatever," right? So you find it, and she says, "You know, do my thing." Then you go to it. Points you to Southampton Estate, not the Excelsior model home. It points you to Southampton Estate here. You go here, and there's a bunch of stingwings or something around. Yeah. You go upstairs. There's Ella's corpse in the corner with her backpack, and she's got a tape. You read the tape. She says, "This is what I was going to do next. Abby helped me out to find the thing, right?" And you install this thing in your Pip-Boy that allows you to track irradiated bone meal, which is basically Deathclaw shit. Yeah. So you read her tape. You read all the options. You install the radio tracker in your Pip-Boy. Then the first thing you fucking do is you find the bone meal. Basically, it's south of here. It's usually past her bunker, and it's like right over here somewhere. There's a Deathclaw nest. You get the bone meal. You kill the Deathclaw, you get the bone meal, right? Then you go to Dire, yeah? The quest marker will say you need nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. There are containers of these things that are lootable that have the item in them when you go to Dire. So this is where you go around and you find the chemicals and shit and whatever the fuck. I'll show you what one of them looks like. It's basically those canister looking things. Yeah. So you come to Dire. Yeah. And you run through here and you kill robots and whatever. And you get the nitrogen, the potassium, and the phosphorus, right? It's one canister of each. So then you got the four materials you need to do your... Oh, shit. This is not good. Okay. So you do that. I mean, the quest is very straightforward. I mean, it tells you everything you need to know. The quest markers aren't broken like they are for trade secrets. So you can actually do the quest by following the markers. It's one of the ones that actually works like it's supposed to. But you run through here, and you get the various things you need. Right? Let me see if I get the pie. Did we get the pie? We getting pie? We are not getting pie. Let's get the ammo off the shelf over here, though, first. Do this, get my 5.56 out of there and the gunpowder. Take another hit on the pie machine, see if we get lucky. Come on, baby boy, reset. I want to see if I get pie. Come on. And? No pie. Okay. So you cruise through here, and one of the containers, they all look the same, and the quest markers point you right to them, so you really won't. You really won't miss them. Yeah. And yeah, there we go. Am I running? R&R on Uncle Sam's dime. So you get the doohickeys, right? And one of them is in this container back here. Yeah. It looks like this. Phosphorus storage, right? If the quest was active, there would be, you know, a diamond quest mark phosphorus. You get one canister of phosphorus, one of potassium, one of nitrogen. Yeah. Then you go put them in the machine. Yeah, let me get this quantum first, though, and get these out of here. Then you go put them in the machine, which is upstairs. This requires killing a shitload of robots. Because when you're using the machines, you're, you know, totally exposed. But you come up here, kill a bunch of bots, whatever. You kill a bunch of bots, and then you go over to this machine over here. This one right here, where the big tanks are, right? You put all three canisters in here, one at a time. You put the death claw right here, and then you use the terminal, and you flush the system, right? Flushing the system flushes all that, you know, fertilizer into the fucking river, okay? Out these pipes right here, right? So what happens from that point on is from those trees there all the way up to where the gulpers are, they can spawn. The strangler blooms can spawn. I generally come down from the dire drop and go down the stream, okay? But when you come out, if the strangler blooms are spawned and active, they will be glowing. There's one right there. It's not glowing. So I don't see it there. I don't see it over there. I don't see any glowing anywhere over here. Okay. It spawns like any other harvestable, world object. But you harvest the strangler blooms. You go to a chem bench. You get some antiseptic, some purified water. I think plastic or steel or something. And you make the rad shield from that. Maybe plastic. But what I do is when I'm farming it, I will server hop right here. I will look for glowing. There's a glow there, strangler blooms there. There's like 15 or 20 different spots they can spawn. Yeah. But after you've done the quest, you will only ever see five at a time. When they spawn, they will spawn in five at a time. It'll pick five at random and you can pick them up. So with Green Thumb, you can get 10, right, at a time. And then with Chemist, you can make 20. And then with Super Duper going, you generally get between 26 and 30. Per run. But that's the entire quest for that. That's how that works. That's how Rad Shield works. And people will buy it. I can sell it for 15 a piece and people will buy it, which I'm very happy about. Oh, look at this. Iktomi, we're going to take a free ride to you. But it's a pretty straightforward quest. It'll take you about 20 minutes. It's not very difficult at all. And Sheck, how's it going? Happy holidays. Welcome to the stream, sir. How are you doing? Ho, ho, ho. Oh, it's a fox. What's up, buddy? Wow, look at this camp. This is cute. Kind of random, but cute nonetheless. What do we got in here? What you got in the machine, homie? Quad suppressed? See? I sold a quad minigun with these stats for 750, so that's a good, I guess I got a good prize, yeah? Unyielding. Sell me, see, the brown for 200, dude. Don't even bother picking up the brown. No one wants the brown one. If they're trying to complete a set, they have long since gotten... Wow, 25 for key cards? I'm going to have to drop my prices on that shit. Red Tactical? Yeah, 50. I swear to God, this guy's selling things out of my inventory, dude. This is the same shit I just been picking up. Okay, he's on the river? Are we on the river? Yeah, we need some glowing. We need some glowing fungus. Let's see if we can't find some glowing fungus. I need to make some soup or something for my daily. Don't talk to me, Scabber.
It's too wet to be outside.
I told you not to talk to me, dude. Okay. Let's see if we can't find some glowing fungus. Give you 25 for... I was selling the key cards for 50, man. But I guess the market is glutted with them, so I'll start selling it for 20. I don't really care about the, I don't really care so much about the money. I just want to get them out of my stash. No wonder they're not moving for 50 if people are selling it for 25, though, and 20. Blasted, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Yeah, it's every Sunday, man, unless I have some sort of event, but I will warn you. If I know about it. Because, you know, I don't really leave the house very much. Being an old guy living with a cat. And, yeah, I'll be on. I mean, if it were Christmas Day, I probably would not be on.
Now it's going to be pouring down rain.
Silence is golden, my friend. Man, where the fuck is the glowing fungus? Normally there's glowing fungus all over the place down the streams here. Is that the only one I got left to do? Kill a Mirelurk. Okay. Well, if we find a Mirelurk, we'll kill him. Well, we hop servers. I can just go back to Lake Reynolds and kill one there. This is so weird. I'm used to... I guess we gotta go down further by the wayward, huh? Alright, fine. We'll do that. Whatever. Whatever. I think the next time the, that highway overpass goes up in the item shop, I might buy it. So I think it'd be fun to put a broken overpass over a stream like this. Might look cool. I didn't got the skill to make it happen, but, you know, maybe somebody else could do the, could take the idea and run with it. Feed the People. Man, Feed the People's been running like crazy all this weekend. Wonder why. People stocking up on that canned meat stew. 5% XP? That's 5% XP, baby boy. XP is XP. Jesus Christ, why can't I find any glowing fungus up here, man? We're in the right biome. Speaking of, I've been playing the shit out of Valheim again, and it's a lot of fun when you can turn off the raids, man. I'm just like, it's so much more peaceful. I can just wander around and do stuff. Give me that. There's a lot of dogs out here today, too, man. There's normally not that many mongrels out here. Two per? I don't have Butcher's Bounty going, do I? Okay, Scabber, you gonna talk?
It's hard work making a living out here.
Is it? Well, looks like it's the end of your shift, buddy. Pipe the fuck down. Scorched? Oh, look, there's a Christmas Scorched. Yay! Because that's the spirit of the season. You want presents, you just kill Santa. Kill Santa, get presents. That's how we do it here in the Commonwealth. Small holiday gift? Is that a one star? Yeah, that stayed on the corpse. Although, you know, I got mutated packs. I should probably open those too. Give me free swimming lessons. Yeah, it's something like that. Here's how to do the dead man's float. There you go, buddy. You're a dead man and you're floating. Anybody over here today? No scavenger trader? Yeah. Ran into two scavenger traders over the last couple days. Both of them selling apparel. Neither of them had a hunter's long coat. That's the RNG saying, fuck you, sir. You get nothing and like it. Didn't even have the longshoreman outfit or the winter coat on him either. I'm just like, y'all motherfuckers suck, man. You need to hook a brother up with some of that stuff. Citadel Forge with Fire is Valheim, but as a wizard. Citadel Forge with Fire. Oh, that's another game? I just like Valheim because it's, honest to God, guys, it's so well designed. It's so well designed that I found out that I like a specific genre of game, a specific type of game. And it's, all right, I'm gonna describe it as the tools and tasks genre. That's what I'm gonna describe it as. The tools and tasks genre. I like games. I strongly prefer games that give you tools and tasks and that's it. And then they get the fuck out of your way and you do whatever you want. And let's get some water here. A bunch of dirty water. But I like tools and tasks. Give me tools and tasks. Yeah? Give me. Hey, 20 dirty water, 10 glowing fungus. There was a camp here, and they just logged out. That's fine, whatever. 45, how's it going? Welcome to the stream. Haven't played this game yet. How do the mutations fit into the lore? Well, you could always get mutated from radiation, okay? How this game differs is you can target those mutations, yeah? By farming specific things in nuke zones, you can craft mutations, yeah? you can craft mutations now for specific effects. And the lore is actually in the Whitespring bunker, where the post-war Enclave personnel researched this shit. They got two research facilities, one in the command center, and one in the Enclave outpost that's underneath the transmission station up here. So the Enclave was absolutely doing post-war research. Yeah. You like Valheim, Citadel, Forge of Fire, came up for Valheim, you can learn to craft flying brooms and ride dragons. I'm not a huge fan of the magic stuff, Clantry, but thank you for the recommendation. I love those types of games. I'm more of a sword and board kind of person when it comes to those types of things. And then when it comes to this, I'm guns. I don't really like throwing spells, which is like, that's why in Skyrim, I was like archers and melees all day long, and I only did one. I never did a full mage run. The only magic run I ever did was in Skyrim. I did a no kill conjurer build. Where my character, the only thing she ever killed was dragons. Everything else, she had minions kill. Right, so she never raised her hand in violence, but she, you know, she took a lot of people who did. And it was surprisingly effective. One takes eyeliner. It's just, I don't think in those terms. It's not something that, like, appeals to me as a player. I like a more direct approach. Magic users, mages are more finessey, yeah? They're more, I mean, I played a mage in WoW, you know, I played a fire mage for a while, but it was a different kind of, oh shit. Let's go to the fuse box. If it's the pipe, I'll go jump up there. Come on, fuse box, what's it gonna be, man? So the pipe is easy when you've got mutations, because you just jump right up here and go right here. I got you, fam. We're good. I know what I'm doing. Now we sit up here and we ride this thing. Get the I usually like the ingredient hopper better, but it looks like there's somebody up there. So I'm just going to camp here. It's just easier to camp here. Screw in fuses. Oh, you know, dude, the fuse... we'll go back out to the... We'll go back to the... I'll show you the fuse. Bucket, we'll do it now. There's plenty of people here, man. Yeah, those are your fuses. It looks like they're plugging, but they use the nut as an anchor. Yeah. Because the wire is wrapped around it. Yeah. I mean, it looks like just a solid brick of ceramic there. That they just slide on and maybe, I don't know. I guess it is, I mean, if the bolt is part of the actual unit, but I don't think you'd want, you know, that kind of metal in there, right? You know what? Fuck it. You're being nice. I'll do it. I'll pop one shit. Why not? I got 43 of them. I got a free one today. Just shoot the ghoul in the face. It's like, whatever, man. Are you still up there? No. Yeah, I'll go back up in my spot. This is my spot. We'll just pop some lunch boxes, man. We're good. Nice, quiet. Had no cover. Well, there was a cover. We'll go back there in a minute. Yeah, fuck, I'll go out now. Why not, man? If you look at it, well, I guess there wasn't a cover. I mean, if there was, it would be a snap-on plate, but it's long since gone. But as we've seen, the world of Fallout is not real big on oh shit here in Smith. They're not big on the old safety thing. Because safety costs money, man. It's just cheaper to pay the fucking... It's just cheaper to pay the inevitable lawsuits, the wrongful death suits and shit, I guess. But I like Valheim. What I like about Valheim is that it doesn't, it's completely self-directed gameplay. You do whatever you want, whenever you want, yeah? And everything is a production when you're playing by yourself, right? If you're playing with other people, you know, you got other people that could do the grunt work and shit. But like right now, the guy I was playing to learn how to play it again, he's early bronze, late stone age, right? So now I'm farming copper and shit. And so you run around the Black Forest, right? You're looking for copper nodes. You're killing shit that gets in your way and whatever the fuck. You're marking them. And then what you do is you build yourself a, a little hut, a little home, you know, a little outpost or fort close to the copper so you can get at it easier, right? So I want to farm copper, right? I need to farm copper. That's my goal. So the first step is find the copper ore, right? Mark it. Then find a place to put a outpost nearby it so I can do the job, yeah? Then start chopping down wood, leveling out the land, build yourself a house, get a bed, get your comfort up, you know, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, since I don't have a bronze pickaxe yet, because I don't want to build them, because you can't fix them without a forge. Then you go up to Ike there again, slaughter him again, get some more fucking hard antlers, build three more pickaxes. Then go back up, furnish the whole goddamn place, get it all set up, build a portal. You're like, all right, because of course, I turned off that whole bullshit, you can't take metal through a portal thing, because it doesn't make any goddamn sense to me. And it's just arbitrary, you know, arbitrary game lengthening and whatever. So I do that. Then you start farming the copper, right? You take your pickaxes out. Your first job is to excavate the edges up to see how big the fucking deposit is. All right. That takes a day and a half. You're like, all right. You're working in the rain, hanging up rocks, not picking up rocks. Then it takes you like a week and a half to excavate the whole fucking thing, move everything back, smelt everything. And it's just like, Jesus Christ, I just want to farm some fucking copper. It turns into this four-hour project. But it's fun, yeah? It's fun doing these things, because you do what you want when you want to do it, yeah? And that's why I like it. Let's go ahead and just eat one of those, because why not? So that's why I like it, yeah? Yeah. You like playing casters? Yeah, well, no, there's people that do that, yeah. It's not a bad thing. I'm not saying it's, you know, being a mage is stupid. It's just... not something I particularly am interested in. Yes. Tension trigger? Sure, why not? You already blew everything up anyways. Okay, let's go back to the White Spring and sell some of this shit. Dun 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 dun. But it's relaxing, you know? Because it's just like, it's just like, I don't know. It's peaceful, right? There's no sound. There's no fucking NPCs talking. The only things that are out there are things that are attacking you. So if you hear a noise, you know it's a fucking enemy. And it's low effort. Yeah. Sitting out there swinging a fucking pickaxe at the ground, dude, is not mentally taxing. It's not something that you spend a lot of mental effort on, but you're being productive, yeah? And then of course, you know, the people who go crazy build amazing shit. Which I can't. I don't have any interest in that. But the good thing is you don't need it, because I'm the only one playing. Nobody else sees the stuff. And get rid of the Daddy-O. Get rid of the Med-X. Get rid of the Rad-X. Get rid of... Okay, I think... Did we... I don't remember if I showed you Dire on this server or not. Let's look and see. Let's go check, right? We're by our camp, so we're going to go look and see if we've got our presence in here. Yeah. See if we have any presents going. See if anything comes out of my highest quality building assets. Well, that's the thing, right? It's basic. Wow, look at all that. Its fundamental gameplay loop is gather stuff to make stuff, to kill the boss, to get stuff, to make better stuff, to kill the next boss, to get better stuff, to kill. So it's a very, very simple, very straightforward gameplay loop. Yeah. I don't have much interest in killing the bosses necessarily. So I just like to fuck around building stuff and running around. It's just, I don't know, it's just fun. So just exploring too, because every map, right, every seed is a proc gen random world. So just running around the meadows in the Black Forest, looking at stuff and seeing how far I can get and how what my world looks like is really fucking cool in its own right, just for its own thing. So yeah. Oh, well, no wonder I had fucking friendly fire on. God damn it. I need to have tenderizer on, dude. What the hell am I doing? Forgot to change that after that radiation rumble last night. Let me give him some super duper going here. Let's smelt that gold. But it's fun. It's, you know, nice change of pace, right? Nice change of pace. From the constant, always on wrecking machine of... Oh, get rid of that one. Get rid of that one. Get rid of this one. Get rid of that one. And then here, we're going to get rid of Covert Operative and Goat Legs, Modern Renegade. And then in here, we're going to get rid of Makeshift Warrior. And here, we're going to get rid of Happy Camper. I need all the rest. And then here, both of these go. I don't need any of those. Awareness, yeah. Skeet Shooter, Tank Killer, I'm good. I must have deleted Butcher's Bounty at some point. And nothing in Strength, huh? Okay, so there's my cards. I got 32 points, 59 perks. What am I doing up here? I need 150 for this. That means I need 118 more, and that's 59 levels, and I have 59 levels. I'm not going to sit here and grind 59 levels with the cards, man. I'm not doing that. But I know I have enough to get my last points in fucking endurance and strength, which is nice. Okay, so what are we doing now? Do we get any Meyer dailies to pop? That doesn't look like it. Let's get some insect repellent done. Let's go talk to him and see if he'll... Well, he probably won't. It might have been too soon. Insect repellent also, guys, I'm telling you, don't sleep on insect repellent, okay? Don't sleep on insect repellent. Insect repellent will save your biscuits a lot if you remember to use it. Okay, Scorched Beast Queen, slap it on, man. You ain't gotta worry about crickets at all anymore. Period. Yeah. K crickets this, K crickets that. I'm all, you knock 15% of their damage on the front, off the front, dude, trust me, they become a lot more manageable. I face tank them. I'm like, come on, you want some of this, you little bitch? You can do that. Scrap that. Okay, let's go do my daily. See if I get a possum badge. Let's see if I can even do the daily. If he doesn't say used up all the insect repellent already, it hasn't reset yet, so... I still gotta kill a fucking Mirelurk, dude. I am totally napping on this shit. Don't ever remember using it. Well, that's the thing. The beautiful part about it, right, is it's a passive. Let me show you. Meat squad here. If you go to 8, insect repellent. Reduces damage from insects by 15% for 30 minutes, dude. Okay? So when the bomb drops, pop this fucker. It'll last the entire Scorched Beast Queen. Yeah? And it's easy to get. You get it from the Stings and Things daily. You talk to this idiot, condescending prick in here, and he's gonna be used up all the insect repellent already. And of course, you want more.
Used up all the insect repellent already, and of course, you want more.
Here's the list. I'm sure you misplaced the last one because he assumes you're functionally retarded. Now, here's a pro tip. You need five things for this. Blood bug. You need a blood bug, you need a blowfly gland, a blood bug proboscis, a stingwing barb, and a tick blood sac, right? Normally you just pick these things up as you adventure, but then you need rad roach meat, okay? Rad roach meat is the only thing in the five that expires, but thankfully there's a rad roach in this room, right? He's right up there, you can see him glowing, right? This one's a glowing one. He's up above the door. When you open the door and go in, he drops off, okay? If you've got mutation, don't even bother unlocking the fucking door. Just jump right over, shoot him, get his shit, jump back out. And you are done, ladies and gentlemen. And you can also hide in the rafters and fuck with newbies if you want to. But that's it, right? That's your rad roach. If, and when you do this, you get three, you always get three insect repellent. Sometimes you get 3 and 2. But sometimes they'll give you a bug grenade, which is like, fuck bug grenades. I don't give a shit about that. Yeah, so we got bug grenades. But we got 3 insect repellents, right? And you can make it yourself if you want to. Yeah. You can make it yourself if you want to. But it's more efficient. You get 3 from him. You only get 1 from making it. With the same parts. Yeah. Man, insect repellent, dude. It'll save your ass. I mean, dude, it's 15% damage reduction. I mean, that's... Resistance reduction? I remember. Don't remember which is which. But it cuts it right off the top. And Cave Creek... Ah, there we go! Bought the knight paint, and he bought the captain paint. Fuck yeah, there's 900 XP's, baby. And he got a deal on them, man, because they normally go for 2,500. Bought my bobblehead endurance? You go, man. Buy all my shit, homie. Let's just go to Highland Mart. Oh, swarm of suitors. I don't want to hop servers right now. God damn it, is it swift-footed? Yeah... How big are you, DK West? Are you a big boy or a small boy? You're a big boy. Okay, good. Bought the drugs. Very good. Very good. Buy all my shit. I don't want to do swarm of suitors, man. The insect repellent ain't no joke. It's peace of mind. You know, when you know there's going to be insects around, like a Scorched Beast Queen, peace of mind, baby. Because it's just one more buff you can add. Oh, they're doing it. All right, well, let's go. Here's my Mire Alert kill, so let's fucking do this shit. Now see if they're smart or if they're stupid. Okay, before we do this, I gotta switch guns. All right. And see, that's why I like bats. I can be a total 360 no-scope motherfucker, yeah? Oops, sorry, man. Didn't mean to get in your way. Here we go. There's my fucking thing. Hooray. The next wave of Mirelurks approaches. Oh, look, we got more camp built shit. Ooh, look at you, level 55 in a blue outfit. Boy, you got lucky, Shinigami. Unless, you know, you just twinking your all, but I'm gonna go ahead and pretend that you actually found that yourself. Cause that's pretty fucking awesome. These guys are fucking hilarious, swift-footed. Damn it. Oh, look, I leveled again. Whee! People we got here? 9? Oh yeah, we'll get the mutated pack from this. Fearless bad guy 0. Man, should have got me in that blue dress, man. Look at you go. Fuck yeah. I am pleased. Oh, and using a bow even. Oh man, that's even better. Okay, so that's definitely an ult. Come on, come out from behind there, dude. You gonna kill him before he gets out? Yeah. I'm not gonna get to shoot him. Oh, nope, there he is. Rock that stagger, baby. Rock that fucking stagger. Damn it, why won't bats fucking target him? Here we go. All done. Yay, hooray. Do we get the mutated party pack? We probably did, yeah? Yeah, perfect. Ghoul Slayer's chainsaw? Look at that shit! Man, if that son of a bitch had been lower weight, I'd be using it. But it isn't, so I'm not. Now, the other guy died up here, right? Yeah, there he is. Okay, well, they both died up here. Good. Excellent. Switch back to my chainsaw. Switch back to my handmade. Yeah, there we go. Perfect. All right. Did our mutated event. Let's go check our thing and see if he cleaned out my my Protectron. I hope he did. I hope he did. I hope it's empty or almost empty when I get here. But yeah, I figure the ho-ho-ho and the flashing light should tell them this is open. Well, maybe he did, maybe he didn't. We'll leave that for the next person. But still haven't sold the junk, man. Right? Yeah, still all in there, man. Jesus Christ, nobody wants to buy my junk. No one wants to fondle my junk, man. Oh, my goodness gracious. So I did all the dailies, all the weeklies, right. Which is, what do we got for a scoreboard? We got some claiming to do. Queen of Hearts poster. Ooh, more atoms. That'll work. Lunchbox times 5. I don't want her to get that. Get the Gatling laser. King and Queen player icons. Oh, that's kind of cute. Okay, icons is cute. Gold bullion 250. Because I want the lunchboxes to go to, I think Faith needs them. And then the gold bullion. Well, how much does she have for bullion? 1500? Yeah, we'll claim it on her. Nobody has time for junk this weekend. Yeah, they, well, I mean, I would think that they would look for junk in case they needed to buy adhesive to make wrapping paper, yeah? But, and I did buy some wrapping paper just to make some presents to see what would happen, but didn't really get anything out of it. Didn't really expect to. You know what? Let's jump to Dire and see if those things have spawned for us. What the hell? We'll go up there. Okay, it's nighttime, which means it's a lot easier. Okay, come here. Where are you guys at? Yeah, I don't see anything glowing here. Come here, come where, dude? There? No. Any hands? Oh, there's somebody else there. Okay. They're just fucking around. Fearless bad guy? A lot of shit in there. Okay, so he was not signaling me, and this is Protectron Horde? I don't really care about that shit. Talk to Roxy, don't really care about that. We did cut out the squatter. We hit the mire, but we don't have our mire daily popping. Waste knot's not up. Cleaning the hunt's not up. Idle explosives is not up. What do I want to do with her now, man? Shit. You know what? Let's just server hop. Fuck it. Nobody's at my camp. Let's see if we can't get some red shield here. Show Glantry how it works. Show you what those little glowing, because when they glow, dude, you can see them. They're very easy to spot. Let's see what we got here. Da di da di di da. Di 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 da. Did we get lucky? It's nighttime, which is good. What you really want to see, though, is it's savage. What it'll say, it's verdant season in the mire. Enjoy the abundance. You see that, man? It's fucking party time, okay? It is fucking party time. But there's one right there. You see that little sumbitch glowing? Okay, so what we do is we switch to Green Thumb, right? Take out Ground Pounder, put in Green Thumb, yeah? Then we go sneaking. Let's go ahead and switch to the Fixer, give me that stealth bonus. But you want to keep a count, because you're only going to see 5 of them. There's a whole bunch of possible spawn points, but only 5 will ever appear at a time. They are very easy to spot. Strangler Bloom. Strangler Bloom 2 added. This is also where you get the swamp tofu stuff. The swamp plant that you make swamp tofu out of. But there's no more glowing here. Sometimes there'll be one up the hill, either here or at the next divot. But they're always down the river. Yeah. Like there's one here. This is just a strangler pod. Yeah. Here's the second one. Lottie Dottie. Come here, you. And then there's sometimes a third one up on this tree up here. Kind of keep an eye out because it's on the... Where's the pod? It's on one of the trees up the hill. I don't know if it's this one or the other one. It doesn't happen very often. So we got two, right? We're looking for three more. There's a bunch on this thing. Nothing there. There's one, two, and then the third one's there. So there's five, right? Here's three. And four. And five. And that's it. Sometimes when you first do the quest, right? When you first do the... when you first flush the river, there will be a sixth one. Because it always spawns one for you to find. Okay? In addition to what's always there. So you get that, yeah? Let me go back to the White Spring. Hope I have enough purified water. Well, you know what? I've got purified water in my camp. Let's make sure I got enough. Because people often leave... If people come to the thing and they see the purified water, they'll either leave it alone or they'll take all of it. There's like no middle ground where they'll just take like two or three or whatever. Small holiday gift. I'll leave that in there. Oh, he did clean me out when he came. Good. Good for you, dude. That's what it's for. Take it all. Did he take the company tea? No, he did not take the company tea. But that's okay. He's probably got a machine of his own. Okay, so we're going to switch back to this. And switch back to this. And there's my reload speed. That's what I like to see. So now, what the hell are they nuking here? What kind of plants? I mean, plenty of fucking spawns to farm. Plenty of spawns to farm high radiation fluids and shit. Water filters? Where'd you get those? The machine that I just did? It's a plan that comes out of the holiday, I guess. It's called a vintage water cooler. It is an expensive plant. Okay? You can find them yourself out of the holiday gifts. The very low odds drop. Or players will sell them in their vendors. Expect to pay anywhere between 8 and 15,000 for one. Yeah, 8 and 15,000 is what they generally go for. I paid 25 for mine. But that's because I needed to burn caps and I didn't care. So the two most important cards when you're making Rad Shield is Chemist, which is you get double the quantity when you craft chems, and Super Duper, which gives you the doubles, right? So right now I have 59 Rad Shield. Okay? I have 59. Remember that number, 59. If I do Rad Shield here, yeah, you need plastic, antiseptic, purified water, and strangler bloom. So I'm making 10. Which will make 20, and with Super Duper, it will make, so 85? Yeah, I made 26. Perfect, right? So 10 from the blooms, 20 from Chemist, and then a 30% chance to make extra, which is only the base amount, for 6 more. So we got 26 out of that. Not too shabby, right? For doing a quest once, and... the beautiful part about Rad Shield is it not only provides more radiation protection than Rad-X, but it lasts longer. Rad-X is 100 rad resist for 10 minutes. Rad Shield gives you 300 for 15. So it's perfect for double dipping at the queen, right? Start it, drop them when the queen pops out, and then at 15 minutes drop another. And it will last the entire run. It will last the entire run of Eviction Notice. It'll last the entire run of Radiation Rumble. So I get my Chinese stealth suit, I pop one, I'm good for the entire event. And it doesn't affect your mutations. Huge bonus. Huge bonus. Insect repellent, and I'm telling you, insect repellent and Rad Shield are the things that people sleep on a lot in this game. I don't know why. Probably because it's just a pain in the ass to get them. Yeah. It's inconvenient to get them. But they sell really good in my machine, so I ain't complaining. Nuke blast zone in the forest, man. What in God's name are you doing? Oh, shit. Let's go do this real quick. Yeah, I forgot. New server. But I'm all about the radiation resistance, right? Because I'm a low skills player. So I am very much belt and suspenders when it comes to protections. Yeah. Very much belt and suspenders. If I got the Chinese stealth suit on, I'm putting Rad Shield on top of it. Just in case. Yeah. If I go to the queen, I'm putting the insect repellent on. Even if I'm perched, dude, I'm putting it on. Because the bugs will attack you, man. And when you're focused on the queen and on other high priority targets, The insects, dude, they will chew you to fucking ribbons because they're small and they're fast and you don't really notice them, yeah? Because the little buzzing they make isn't really audible, you know, with all the other screaming and shooting and gunfire and explosions and the queen breathing all over everything. It's just like, you don't hear them, yeah? You get a tick in the grass or an ant in the grass or a cricket you didn't fucking see, dude, they will annihilate you, dude. And you're like, why the fuck am I dying? What the hell is it killing me? Yeah? So, but that's what I do, right? I run through with my vats and I clean up the trash for the heavies. That's my job in the support role. People say there's no support role in this game. I'm all, oh yes, there is. It's just not called support. It's called the non-XP task, but that's the support role. And I am happy to do it, dude. Because it doesn't take, you know, skill. I'm a big fan of stuff that doesn't take any skill because, well, you know. We're operating on a skill deficit here, yeah? Also, it's good to get in the habit of, once you started getting insect repellent, you will be keeping an eye out for bug parts, right? You'll be keyed on bug parts. Pick them up anyway because they scrap into acid. And you can sell acid. People will buy acid. Trust me on this one. Loose, well, you bought them all. 499 loose screws for a cap apiece. Man, you must have pooped your pants when you saw that Gulfy Breeze. He's like, holy shit, this guy's selling 500 screws for a cap. Yeah, I am, dude. Buy them all. Buy all the things. Buy everything, dude. About the bone shards? Okay, good. You're making oil. Ballistic fibers going? Good. Yeah, baby, clean me out. Burn those caps. That's what it's there for. If you want to sell it in your own machine at a higher price, be my guest. Nothing there. There's the white uniform, and in here we've got another white uniform. White dirty? Yeah, fuck you, man. I mean, odds-wise, those ones have come up. But still, man, I'd love to hit a red or a force on the stream. You guys will be, oh my god. I'd be like, yep, yeah, 1 in 10,000, homie. We got it. Unfucking believable. But we did get the Rad Barrel plant that one time. I mean, that's 2.5%, so that's not as rare as everything else. Still pretty exciting, though. Pretty exciting when my hard work pays off. Also, I think I'm selling my magazines too cheap. I sell magazines for 10 caps a piece, right? The ones that I sell. I don't sell Backwoodsman 3 or Live and Love 8, but I sell all the other ones. And I literally sell them for 10 caps a piece, man. And people will buy them all when they see them. Are magazines really that valuable? Do people use them? I guess clearly they do because they're buying them. You're buying steel scrap, or you're really burning caps, ain't you, dude? What do you got here? Jack revolver? No. Got his camp set up. Missed drifts? Got set up right at West Tech. Yeah. Someone's getting those levels. People remember those deals? Oh, yeah. I am sure I am on friends lists, on people's notification lists, right? When they see my camp, they're like, yeah, this guy's got the jump. This guy's got the jump. Okay, I'm not going to mess. I'm not going to get in her way. I'm simply going to check her camp out. And it's looking, yeah. Oh, it's on. Oh, it's on the backside. Oh. Most of the time, people build their camps up on the at the intersection up there on the other side. West Tech Express. Miss Drift, I like your style. It's the West Tech Express. Fuck yeah, it is, man. I might as well stand up. She can see my dot on the map anyway. West Tech, I know, love it, right? It's just like, lean into that shit, man. You do it. Quad short pump out. Wow. Wow, you must have fucking cried when you see this thing come off a thing. If that had been a fixer, dude. Son of a bitch, dude. Those are the heartbreakers. When you see the G-roll stats on a non-popular weapon, man. It's like, son of a bitch. 300, a fucking Q25-25, dude, on a pump-action shotgun. That's sad. Yeah, standard sights. You didn't get the reflex sights on it. Oh, what a heartbreaker that shotgun is, man. Oh, what a fucking heartbreaker that is. Oh, what a heartbreaker that is. Oh, on a rolling pin. Yeah, it'd almost be better if it was on a rolling pin, because then you could turn it to a collector, right? Because there are people who collect that shit, right? I did not know this. Like one time I did an eviction notice, and I got a BSS 1S rolling pin. Yeah, bloody, swing speed, and one strength, right? The god roll for a melee weapon, but it was on a fucking rolling pin. And I'm like, are you kidding me? So I'm like, you know what? I went to the trading forums, and I'm like, hey, man, I got this fucking BSS. I'll take offers and shit. And this guy offered me, like, I don't know. It was something that was decent. And I'm like, that's fine. I'll fucking take it and whatever. And the thread exploded, dude. It exploded. People were trying to trade him for that thing on the thread. Right? I'm like, wait a minute. Is this thing really that fucking valuable? And they're like, this is like a collector's wet dream, dude. This is like the worst possible weapon, the best possible roll. People love this shit. I was like, fuck, I wish I'd have known. I didn't even know. And they're like, dude, I'll trade it back. I'm like, no. We trade it fair and square. My stupidity is not your fucking problem. You're not responsible for my idiocy, dude. But holy shit, dude. They were trading massive amounts of shit for this fucking rolling pin, dude. And I was just like, all right, well, I guess I should do market research next time. Yeah, whatever. But most of the time, I don't mind selling this stuff that's wasted legendary effects. It is. I mean, for using, yeah. But if you're making a collection of swing speed, if you're making a collection of every effect, swing speed, one strength on rolling pins, that's a collector's item, you know? So whenever I get a melee weapon, that's a weird, a swing speed, one strength, and then has some kind of weird legendary effect, like fucking hunters or whatever, I'll float it out there. Any collectors want this, man, just make me a decent offer. Just buy it from me. I don't really even care. You know, they're happy as hell because they got the item they wanted, right? They got that hole in their collection. Yeah. People collect the weirdest shit, but I mean, yeah. You run bloody knuckles. 3-star mutant. Yeah, it's just, but that's the thing. If you sell it cheap, right? If you sell those kind of one-off weapons cheap, people will buy them. Because they're like, I want to try this out, right? But I don't want to spend 5,500 caps on it. I'll spend 1,200 to try it. Like, one of my best weapons is on Garnet. She's got a QE. It's a quad. Is it quad explosive? 10mm submachine gun? And I'm like, this is the kind of weapon you're like, yeah, you know, I'll take this out and fuck around with it. But you want to price it at fuck around prices, right? So people will buy it. Like the other day, I found she found a quad fire rate minigun. Yeah, quad faster fire rate minigun. That's it, 2-stars. And I'm like, you know what? Someone will probably love this weapon, but I'm not gonna sell it for a ton of money. So I put it in there for $750, and it was gone in like 20 minutes. So I'm like, maybe I should have asked more for it. But whatever. Someone got a good deal. They got the weapon they wanted. They're happy. I'm happy. Everybody's happy. Because I don't care. It's just stuff. Now, if it was a G-roll, that'd be a different story. You know what? Demon Slayers LY, you're 196 and you got 12 weapons? Okay, we're going to play the odds. 12 weapons, very likely script dump. Very likely a script dump. But they're 196. So the odds are not zero that they could have run an eviction notice and come out with something really fucking nice. Or something that I want. So we're going to see what they've got. We're going to gamble 15 caps to see if they've got a weapon that's not an absolute trash fire. Is its own reward. Sometimes a wet and dirty. All right, what do you got, homie? What's in here, Demon Slayers? Script. 100% script dump. Yeah, bloody bash damage. Whatever, dude, it's not a melee weapon. But sometimes, right? Sometimes they'll be selling a weapon in here that I want. What I'm looking for more than anything else are 90% reduced weight chainsaws. I don't really care so much about the effects, the other effects on them. Although vampires would be nice. Because I use a chainsaw in events that require a chainsaw. Yeah. That I heal at or that have you got a bot walking around?
Collect.
And you've got, wow, you haven't changed the presence, huh? Interesting. Okay. Uranium fever, one person. Do I even want to do this? I mean, yeah, Urban Scout bundle, Savage Divine bundle drop. I'm so sick of Uranium Fever, man. I'm just sick of Uranium Fever. NC Country Boy, is he my team leader? Yeah, fuck it. We'll go help him out. Again, Rad Shield good for this one too, right? Because those little uranium things throw off enough radiation when you go to fix them, it can be problematic. Are we outside? We're outside. Okay. So I'm going to go inside and do a little bit of farming. We're going to hope he starts it. Where is he at? Is he even in there? Well, he's in there. Is he doing the same thing I'm doing? He's just waiting for somebody else to come start it? 218? I mean... I'll stick my rad shield. Do I got... I got 25 minutes on very well rested. Let's switch weapons. Fixer's better in here because it's close up work. Fuck it.
Please stop and approach for identification.
Okay. So fuck it. Let's just run this, man. I can solo this shit. I'm not even worried about it. And it's good XP because I got the goddamn thing running. Somebody bought most of my steel, so I can just do that. Yeah, he ran through here because he killed all the shit. Okay, NC Country Boy, you gonna fire it up? I mean, anytime you want to, dude. I'm not gonna trip. Okay, let's grab this and this. And then we'll grab the copper. Here's an orange one here on the left. And then a rusty one right there. And we're gonna see if he grabbed that concrete. If he did not, I'm grabbing it right now. There's three cement bags right here. Pick them up. Cement cells. What you doing, man? You AFK in here, dude? You choking the chicken in here, bud boy? You just hanging out? Did you AFK it? I mean, all right. Well, we're gonna do this, dude. So I'm gonna fire it up. We're gonna get this party started. I'll get you some XP for free. You just hang out.
Extraction process initiated.
Cause I don't give an actual fuck.
Extraction units while operational.
Hostile trespassers. What? Oh, God.
Hostile trespassers detected. Employees.
I'm gonna say, man, I'm like, Jesus Christ, what the hell is?
Damage to extractor units occurs.
What the hell is not starting? What's up, big guy? God damn it! What the fuck is going on with bats, man? It's not working! Oh, stagger. Such a weak, lazy fucking mechanic. Yes, I'm gonna bitch about that till the end of fucking time. Cause it's weak and lazy. It's weak and lazy. Ugh, whatever, dude. Alright. Where you at? You in here? I hear you, dude. Here you are. God damn it. Here we go. Alright. You know what? Let's go first person. We don't need third person here right now. You guys want it? You don't.
Detecting terminated management personnel. Remove this individual from the premises.
Good job. Burn him down, dude. Because when he's out, the timer stops. God damn it. Let me jump, dude. since he's not gonna fix them.
Adequate uranium volume extracted and processed. Output quantity increased.
What the fuck, dude? God damn it. Where the hell is he shooting from? There he is. Alright. Da da da. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. What? Where are you at? There you are. What's up, buddy? Thank you. Get some good XP in here, though. So, I mean, it's something.
Detecting terminated management personnel. Remove this individual from the premises.
Where is he? Oh, stagger. Hmm. Right. We can cheat. Oh, he's right there. Okay. Okay, 3 minutes on the clock here? No? Yes? Yeah, party time indeed. Okay, we did it at 3 minutes, so hopefully we'll make it 404. I don't know if it matters, probably doesn't, but what the hell, man? Gotta have goals, yeah? Alright, where are we going here? No? No? Nice, uh-oh. I saw that. Lawnmower! Yeah, take your stagger and fuck yourself, dude. It's in there. Where the hell do you guys think you're going? I don't think so. Sorry, Mr. Mole Miner, we're closed. See, normally I like to have the 50 bats, but at these ranges, dude, it's not gonna matter. This gun will do just fine. Feeling like a power gamer in here, man. Just murdering shit wholesale. It's like, alright, we'll murder you. A lot of meat on the street. 130? We're gonna be close. It's gonna be close, ladies and gentlemen. You gonna get him, homie? You're over there. You got him? Good. Excellent. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Da-da-da. Anybody here? Nope. Cool. That's a lot of mole miners, man. Christopher, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Yeah, I play support roles, right? So when I do these events, I am key to not killing things. I'm key to fixing things. Yeah. I'm the one who rides the scrubber. I run the ore. I shake the staff. I hold the pylons. I do all the non-XP stuff, right? Because I don't really care that much about XP. And if I did, I would just grind West Tech, because God knows I know how to kill them fucking super mutants. So I can get XP and loot anywhere. I don't really give a shit. When I do the events, I want to do the events, yeah? And, God damn it, where are you? Bravo, son of a bitch, dude. Oh, look, I leveled again. Whee!
Extraction complete.
Nah, we only get three of four, son of a bitch. It probably doesn't matter, but if it does, I want to improve my odds as much as possible. Alright. But welcome to the stream, Christopher. How are you doing? You came in an opportune time because it's Mole Miner Central today! I don't give a shit about any of this other crap. Let's do this. Oh, the other guy must have crashed out. Because he ain't here no mo. Alright. Assassin's machete? Pfft, whatever. Okay. Ooh, anti-armor machine gun, huh? Not bad. So, here's your radius. Here's a perfect example. I looted him here, okay? This is where I looted him. I looted everything up to here to those piles, right? This corpse was in range. These piles were not, okay? So that's what, about 30 feet, maybe? 40 feet into that room. So that's your radius for area loot, about 30 feet. Looks like. At least indoors. Yeah. Outdoors probably different, because I know when I loot the super mutants, the eviction notice, I loot them from all over the goddamn zip code. So, I don't know. We'll see. But that's okay. But we did a uranium favor. Whoop-de-fucking-do. Another the 900 millionth. They smell like teen spirit. They probably smell like flop sweat, dude. They've been trapped in those fucking suits, and they're molded their bodies. They've been there for 25 fucking years, dude. It's gotta be pretty rank in there by now. It's so stinky, it goes beyond stink. It's like the meta of stink. It doesn't even smell anymore because there's no smells left. There's no molecules left to generate smell. It's like, or odor. Uh-oh, is that duct tape? It sure is. Came from over here, right? Yeah, sure did. Is the handmade glue up? Did I get the handmade glue? Also, more cement there. So there are five bags of cement in here. One on the outside by the bot, three on the stack on the over there by Charlie, and then one on this shelf in here. So you can get some concrete. Yeah? You can get some concrete out of it. They're fused. Oh, they're absolutely fused, their skin, dude. It is nastiness personified. Launched a nuke, huh? I'm not in the mood. I gotta go to the... Gotta stretch. Too much combat makes my neck...
Attention, citizens. Nuclear strike.
So how many of these fuckers did I kill this time?
Please exit the area.
Just take the number of bones, mole rat teeth, and divide by two. That's how many of these guys that I killed.
Cooperation.
No, it's a suit. It's the Garahan. It's the Garahan suit. So we killed 39 of them this time. That's a lot of fucking mole miners. But no, they're actual human beings, dude. They're mutated human beings that were, nobody really knows what their origin is, but they're miners. Yeah, they're pre-war miners, and they were part of the, clearly part of the striker union action, where they don't like you fucking with their, they don't like automation of any kind, yeah? And they will fucking attack you. And they work for Garahan, that I know, because that's absolutely a Garahan mining outfit. Yeah. You can get the Garahan outfit from one of the various mole miner pails or gift boxes or whatever. But let's see if we can find a corpse here that's on his back. Yeah. But you can see, right? They got the gas mask on. Right, they got the gas mask on. You can see their eyes sticking out through the cloth of the original mask. Then you've got the hood, yeah, and the belts of the old uniform are right there. Three belts across the front. It's basically a big old trench coat with canvas underneath, yeah, and the basic shoes. But yeah, they're in their thing. And there's their hands, yeah. They're not terribly in good shape, and they're very angry. I mean, really, who wouldn't be? But I'm doing them a favor by killing them. They do the dirt with mole rats. They've just been underground for 25 years, dude. They're hyper irradiated, right? They've been living underground And they're still bitter about very many things. So there's been no clear lore on their actual origin. Yeah. So it's unknown whether... Well, I forgot to do it. See, I fast traveled. And my AP didn't go down, so now it'll work. Yeah. Here we go. Okay, any presents? No presents. Oh, no presents. We'll get those. Mistrid left the team. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go stretch because I need to stretch. And bio, while we're thinking about it. And it's what? Scorched earth, yeah. Not doing it. Sorry, vaporing cone, but I'm going to have to sit down here. So we're going to take a little intermission here, as we do at this time, because I'm old and I need to stretch. And holy Jesus, do I need to stretch. So we're going to go 3 to 5 minutes, folks. Refill your drinks, snacks, smoke them if you got them. Stretch like I'm going to, and I'll be right back.
Protect.
And we are back in Dalton. Welcome to the stream. Yeah, I'm on old man creaky bones, tense muscles, fucking stretch break, dude. That's what I was on. I just, you know, you know what? Is it still going? Six? Where's the blast? Yeah, let's go. Fuck it. Let's see if it's still. Let's see if we can horn in on this and get 1,000 points before she dies. Of course, you know what? They're probably farming her. I forgot. Because the Scorched come out. The Scorched, maybe we should take up yoga. Yeah. Okay, so first thing we do, right? Rad shield and insect repellent. And off we go. Why am I not in this event? 24-24, okay, good. How is she doing? Oh, we're not gonna get our 1,000. God damn it, they're not farming the Scorched. Okay, this is gonna be close. Let's see if we can get our, damage in time. I did not expect them to melt her like this. We need to get our 1,000 so I get my flux, man. Need to get my flux, babies. I wish there was a counter that told me how much damage I was doing to her, you know? And dead. Now we're gonna run the field, right? Do our turret shit as we do. Scorched ant, huh? See, I don't want the heavies having to shoot down the dirt, right? I want them to look up. Yeah. Scorched cave cricket? Yeah, I'm not worried about scorpions either, bitch. Come on, I'm gonna face tank it. Let's do it. Well, I get to loot her, so I got the points. Remember, kids, don't fucking loot until the shooting stops. Yeah? Don't fucking loot until the shooting stops. Because the last thing you want is to die after the event. Because you will drop all that flux. Okay. Nice and quiet. Now we can loot. Now we can loot. Yoink! Treasury note. Oh, you fuckers! I did 1,000 points to her. Have you kissed my ass, dude? I dumped 2 mags into her, dude. What bullshit? Oh, son! I got looting rights, but no flux. You guys suck. You guys suck. That's bullshit, dude. I did 1,000 points. Oh, what? We get free shit here. Ooh, let's get the free shit here. Oh, yeah, the free shit. Oh, free shit. Oh, free shit. Give me the free shit. Yes. Give me the free shit. Any more free shit? No? Where's she at? I hear you. Oh, yeah, you made a bad choice today. Real bad choice today, sister. Oh, that was a bad choice. Do I have? No, transfer? Okay. Jim, how you doing? Welcome to the stream, and happy holidays to you. Free shit. Speaking of, okay, thank you for reminding me. At the end of the season, I'm going to delete this character, okay? Literally going to delete her. So, if you are on Xbox, and you have, and you want anything that she's got, I mean, I've got a ton of decent stuff. I mean, I could just, you know, whatever. I'll just give it to you. Just let me know, and we'll coordinate a time to hook up. I'm not going to hook up with you. But I mean, coordinate a time to join the same server, and I'll dump it all in like a donation box at some random train station for you. And if you got first, you can just drop your survival tent, and you can, and yes, and thank you very much, Groucho and company, Groucho and Glantry, for promoting the community. Very, very good. But if you wanted this stuff, man, I'm just going to dump it in a random crate and log off and delete it like I always do. So, if there's anything in here that interests you, you know, let me know, and we'll, I can just give it to you instead. It's all the same to me. Little man's is grooming. It's always good to see him grooming. and give it to noobs. You have too many things. You never keep anything because loot is plentiful. Exactly. The thing is, this time around, Jim, I did the technical data thing. So I've got knight captain paint. I have knight sergeant paints, and I have knight paints. Yeah. Which, you know, if you've done the elder paint, you can't get those unless you buy them from people. I sell them for 1,000 caps. Game Town walkthrough. How's it going? Welcome to stream. Happy holidays. How are you doing? You just doing a drive-by? All right, do a drive-by, man. Good to see you anyway. Thanks for taking the time. Thanks for taking the time to hop in this cranky old man's fucking stream and go, yeah, this didn't suck. All right, let's turn in whatever legendaries we got. Let's see what we got. Aristocrat's torso? That's trash. God, I wish that was 90 weight. Oh, I wish that was 90 weight, but it's not. 48, huh? That's a 12. 39. And 36. So the bottom two I'm going to be keeping for later. Okay, 16. Okay, anything else in here I want? Yeah, nothing I want. All right. We're going to drop these in here for later because that's what we do. And put that in there and put that in there. Sell some shit. Actually, let's cook the meat for the XP because what the fuck? It's XP. La-di-da-di. Pitch a tent and get free stuff. In a way, that is exactly what I'm saying, but maybe not in that particular context. You know, we're just going to put that out there. Leave that on. We're going to leave that one on the table, I think. That'll be fine. But yes, that isn't in fact what I was saying. But I got to make sure your tent is acceptable. Yes. Make sure that we have here to help you. Fuck you, hard dude. Here to help yourself, man. But that's okay. It works out. It works out for everybody. That's really the bottom line here. Yeah, it works out for everybody. Then dump all this fucking meat in here because I don't even need it. It's like, whatever. It's fine. Get rid of this and those and this and that and these and those. And then in here we've got glowing blood. We can dump that and right away. Get rid of those. And Excel. Yeah, get rid of that. All right. Now we're going to clean out our inventory a little bit here, and you heading out, Noel? Okay, thank you for stopping by. Good to see you. Hope you enjoyed the stream. Whatever, you know, whatever disastrous this thing was. I think I'm going to hop servers again, though. Notes. Get rid of that. Get rid of the ultrite right arm. Get rid of the jetpack. Get rid of this. Get rid of that. Get rid of those. Didn't get anything of a note, so that's... Oh, Grognak and the Robbie. Where did I get that from? I don't even remember where the hell I got that from. Anything at the bottom? No, nothing there. Okay, good. And drop the ore, too. Shit, why not? Somebody else can turn that into gold if they want to. Okay. Black Dog McCree. All right. You know what your bad self, man. 1068, and then in here we've got... drop that in there, and drop that in there, and drop those in there. So far for holiday gifts, I have 44 holiday gifts, 13 large, and 59 small that she's just been accumulating as I play. Don't really, at the end of the stream, we're going to open them all. I'm just going to open them all. The trick to opening the gifts, just so you know, open them slow. Apparently Angry Turtle and other people have done testing on this. And if you open them quickly... If you spam them, it doesn't... The RNG works weird. Yeah? You will get more quote-unquote rolls and more opportunities to get the plans if you go slow. I don't know why this is, but they've tested it. And people who test things... I am okay with this. I'm okay with people who test things. I'm happy with people who test things. Yeah? Okay. And then handmade, right? Okay. Any casual teams? Two there, one there, two there, one there. Guys, really? Could you just fuck it? Wow, there's some lag here. Testing is fun. Yeah, dude, amassing data is fun. if you know what you're doing. Why didn't I not join? Oh, it's offline. Son of a bitch. Well, we're going to join this team then. Who's running? Marathoner, Stars, Jeans, Curator, and Inspirational. Okay, good. Nobody's running Inspirational except me. Are they mutated? Let's find out. Are they mutated? They better be. Yes, they're mutated. Okay. Testing is a pain in the neck. Yeah, it's a thing, but it's just, I don't know. I find it interesting to amass data so you can make actual, you know, analysis. You know, people say, well, it feels like, I don't care what it feels like, dude. Your feelings are fucking irrelevant. What I need to know is what your data look like. Yep, locked. Okay. Not judging. It's more of a data compilation. It's like, how many people lock their things versus how many people? Okay, what do we got here? Anything good in here, homie? Troubleshooter's chainsaw? Executioners? See, the chainsaw thing, I need a 3-star chainsaw, yeah? I absolutely have to have a 3-star chainsaw because I need that 90% reduced weight. Because it's not my 100 for a night uniform, huh? You can get 150 for that, kiddo. Just FYI. Oh, the getaway wagon. Okay, so you're cool then. I don't know, 100 for a rusticle banner. That's a little bit steep. But it's your camp. You make your own prices, big guy. A lot of popular 3 armor. You know what? Fuck this, nah. Gotta run the asylum again. Sorry, this is my part of my ritual, part of my routine. First thing I do, man, check. Because you never know. You never know if that fucker's going to pop. We got a brown one today. We saw a brown one today. So I know that that spawn spot, because I didn't take it, right? So I know that spawn spot is eligible. So we're gonna look here. We're going to go look. See what we get. Dun, 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 dun. Is the fan up? The fan is not up. Okay, that means the pepper won't be up. The key is, if they're mutated, again, this is my test, can I jump to the second floor? Yes. Okay, they're mutated. They are mutated. Let us go upstairs. Ooh, ballistic fiber. Nope, not there. Okay, that's one. Now, I remember the brown one we saw was in the shower, so I know the shower is an eligible spawn spot, of course. Nothing is a particular spawn, or somebody could have grabbed it. There's no way to know. And it's white. White and dirty? No, just plain white. That's fine. Let's see if we get a plan up here. There's a plan in a mod box on those metal shelves in that crash cart by the power armor frame. And I farm that shit mercilessly, because that's like free money when I see that. What have we got here? Intelligence? That'll work. It ain't leadership, but it's intelligence. It's 2 intelligence, 4 XP. It's not terrible. And nothing. Okay, cool. We'll take the adhesive off of here. Might as well grab this shit and get the things that we need to get here. Ooh, Stimpak. And in here, nothing. In here, almost always nothing. That's good. Alright, cool. 1, 2, 3. Plenty of acid. What have we got in inventory? Nothing. Still working the shield flannel, right? Because it's 3 intelligence. What's my intelligence right now? 17. It's not bad. Not great, but it ain't bad. Let's go ahead and do... Let's go look for more presents. How about that? Let's go look for more presents. Let's see if we can find some more presents. Get some Brotherhood Steel shit, too. While we're here. Oh, there's one right there. Wake him up. Make sure he switches to his melee weapon. Okay. Sometimes they don't have a melee weapon. Sometimes they have fists. But you don't want to kill him straight up. Because the game will not spawn the present unless it has time to go back and forth to the server to tell your game this guy is valid. Yeah. And he's got multi-purpose axe. Yeah, I'll take it. Why not? Okay, camera, fan, telephone. What? Look, Kung Fu, keep your ass down. Why are you up, dude? Telephone. Uh-oh, I hear him. I heard him. Boy, that's faint, isn't it? Nocturnal Fat Man, and that's a waste of fucking time. Magazine? No magazine. But tongs? Tongs mean screw. Well, screws, loose screws. What? What is up with the Kung Fu Scorched in here today? And why are they all riled up? Normally they're nice and quiet. Oh, here's the camera. Are you in here? Moonshine Jamboree. Baby boys, it is time to fucking get paid. Holy Jesus, this is going to be a shit fest. Okay, let me get the orange mentats here. See if we've got the, is the door open? No, the door's not. Oh, look at this, a third one? We cashed in today. Come on. Large holiday gift, very nice. Berserkers 10mm? Well, you know what? It's one star. Well, I'll take it. 45, 556, bobby pin. All right, is the bobblehead here? Yes. Caps? No. Charisma. All right. Let's peek in the window. Let's see if the, see if it's in there. It's in there. Son of a bitch. Okay, let's pick this fucking lock. Bow, bow, bow. Oh, hello there. Are you here to make some moonshine? Yeah. I like that guy. Okay, nothing in there. And now we're going to check to see if there's another hat, and then we're going to Moonshine Jamboree, because fuck this, man. Plastic cork. I'll take that. Close the door, and nothing there. All right, Moonshine Jamboree, here we come. Oh, it's resilient, too. Yeah. Time to get the grinder out, baby. Oh, you haven't started. I better not have started already, you son of a bitch. Okay, first thing we do is we switch to makeshift warrior. Absolutely, right? Because otherwise my chainsaw is going to be... and then what we're going to do is we're going to... we're going to make sure we're topped off on our food. Yeah, absolutely get our perfect bubblegum going. Right? We're going to use a repair kit on this thing because I know it's... Yeah, I know it's... yeah, that'll help me out. And then... Another stray comes to our cozy cabin. Indeed. Indeed, my friend, indeed. All right, bitches, I'm ready. Yeah, I'm ready. Let's get lunch boxes. Let's get these things queued up and get ready to go. Loot those cans. Yeah, the ones in the thing over here. That's good. That's good gun. That's good bullet making material right in here. All those three shelves and a bunch of shit scattered on the floor. Don't forget to pick up the screws and the lead from these the toys there, and the plastic from the plastic and lead from the rocket. Wait for the jamboree to begin. Oh, I'm ready. I'm ready, motherfuckers. We're ready to go. I think we're ready to get this jamboree going. Light the fire, moonshiners. Try not to shoot each other. There will be no shooting here, buddy. I'm all about the chainsaw, bitch. We're gonna fuck shit up.
Well, I think we're ready. To get this jamboree going. Light the fire,
pop a couple of lunch boxes and then get a scout banner going. Because I've got 17 of them for some reason. I have no idea where these come from. Alright, bitches, let's party. It's fucking time. There go the lunch boxes, man. Woohoo! Let's go, ladies and gentlemen. Let's get this shit started. I'm protecting the stills, man. Where the fuck are the critters, dude? There you are. The motherfucker, you want some? Oh yeah, no, sorry. We're closed. Yeah, here we go. No, you don't need a swing, dude. I got it. You just need to fucking... You just need to, you just torch things up there, Johnny Storm. Flame on. I got the resilient part. We're not gonna get them. We're not coming past here. No. Oh yeah, dude. Turn on the grinder. What's up? Oh, look, I leveled again. Look at Miko. Whee! Come on, boys. You want some? That's right. circle strafe around them, right? Because they won't stagger if you're behind them. You found the tub. I can't say that for many of the moonshiners who come through here. Oh god, the guy's on the rubber. He's in the rubber swamp thing. What are you doing, dude? Oh yeah, that's what's up. This is so fucking stupid, though. I love this event with Resilient so much. I didn't think I was gonna like mutated events, but this shit's hilarious, dude. Look, we're not doing that, homie. Look, dude, you barbecue him, and I'll go ahead and supply the cutting. We'll cut a chunk off for you. We got it. Yay, my adhesive sold! Hooray! Boon Daddy, thank you. Thank you very much for your patronage. Oh no, 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 you need to die right now. No anglers! That's right, man. You cook them, dude. And I'll, you flambé them, and I'll go ahead and cut them into chunks. Okay, the field's still. Watch it. Watch him run right into this. You little shit. Come on. Hitboxes? Nah, that's details. Whatever. Eat a dick, dude. Okay. Let's just get in the middle of shit and just start chopping it up, buddy. This is what we're doing right here. This is so fucking stupid, dude. I love this so much. Alright. How's the field still doing? You guys in there? Okay, you're in there. Oh no, you're gonna die right now, Bubba. No, we're doing this right now. Mm-mm. No. I hate you motherfuckers so much. No, you're dying. Homie. It's getting a little meaty up in here. I put up on the roof and shit. How slippery be in real life? Yeah, no, right? No, she's got grippy boots, man. That's my headcanon. She has grippy boots. She's using the waders. You got it, man. We have just enough venom to make a batch. And there's still plenty of room in the tub. Let's see how much more we can collect. No, I must have enough by now, dude.
Destroying stills are not good for making moonshine. Need I say more?
Drifter outfit, nice. You really outdone yourselves, yeah? God damn it. Very active, active play style here. You wouldn't think it would be, but it totally is. Whee! Somehow I'm underwater there. I'm not quite sure how that worked. Look at this shit. Just stand in the doorway and just hold the trigger down. Kind of whatever. Oh, look, I leveled five levels, dude. We hit 250 earlier today, now over 255. It's like, okay, man, I mean... Oh, he fell off the roof. What are we doing here? What are we doing here? This looks so stinking kooky. How you doing? Welcome to the stream. Well, the thing is, okay, so this event, right, normally is it's a bloodbath anyways. But this is a mutated event, which means you have to do melee damage to kill them, right? You can shoot until they're almost dead, but they won't die unless a melee attack gets them. So what I do is say, fuck it, let everybody else shoot, get out here with the chainsaw, and guard one of the stills, right? And just hold the trigger down. Okay? It gets a little chaotic, yeah. But it's fucking hilarious, dude. It's just so stupid. Because it's just it's a non-stop meat, it's a non-stop butcher factory, yeah? It's a slaughterhouse. And welcome to the stream and happy holidays to you, sir. Good to see you. Thanks for stopping in on this busy Christmas Eve day. Okay, now it's wave four. Now we go for wave four. There's another wave. There's an entirely another wave here. Tie him up, right? Come on, man. Let's team up. There you go. Get your shred minigun out. Let's murder some shit, dude. What do you think? This is so fucking stupid, though, man. It's the kind of event where you just sit and laugh the entire time, because it is just so dumb, dude. It is so dumb. It is a freight train of XP, yeah? And there's no skill required. I just basically hold the trigger down and just kind of point my cursor in their general direction and erase them as they try and get in here. See, you could finesse it, right? I could sit here and be all... God damn it. See, what sucks is when you get staggered, right? Because you got to double rev the chainsaw to get it to work again because it's bugged. This is what a Metallica concert is like in the wasteland. This is the mosh pit from hell, dude. We need some like Swedish death metal playing right now, just for the full effect. Yeah. Da-dun, da-dun, da-dun. Play the doom music. Yeah. Da-dun, 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 da-dun. You just meet everywhere, dude. Oh. Buggered by a chainsaw. Yeah, it's yeah. And there we go, all done. I don't even know, 2-3 levels there. I didn't even know what we got, dude. Boop! Oh, look at that, another fucking bonus. Let's get our next bullion here. 250? Sure, why not, I'll take it. Just chew them up, dude. I'm just like, yeah, okay. Take the meat here, because we're going to need that for, Okay, so we did that. Let's go ahead and switch. We'd like to open it? Sure, why not? Let's get rid of makeshift warrior and put in gunsmith. Switch back to my weapon. And let's go to the house and look for some wood, because I'm going to need some wood, because... All this cooking of this meat takes a lot of wood, and I always forget to gather wood. I generally avoid scrapping or picking up things that have wood in them. I don't use wood for very much, but here, man, I'm literally using wood by the hundreds. Yeah, look at this. See, they left the spice and the sugar for me. So nice. And the cooking oil, that's just free money for me, man. Thank you. You left me these, and you left me the toaster. I bet the fucking there's nothing in. Yeah, you left me this too. Very good. Oil and some lead and some steel. Did you get everything off here? No, you left the screws for me. Thank you. More lead and acid and copper. And then the Wake Master Alarm Clock's cut off. God damn it, you picked the fucking thing up. Thank you. And this Wake Master Alarm Clock's got all kinds of good shit in it. Is the Brad Rush still alive? Nope. Okay. That'd be more meat to cook, yeah? It's time to cook, Jesse. Or elevator music. Yeah. I don't know, man. Just something. But it's just, I don't know why, dude. That event just cracks me up. And of course, it is a flat out XP freight train. It's just stupid. Stupid how much XP you get out of this. Go for energy. I'll take those, dude. That's XP. You're leaving XP on the floor, dude. What are you doing? Don't leave XP on the floor. That's XP. Did you leave it in here, too? Heavy combat armor? I'll take that, sure. I can always use the stuff. All right. So now let's go ahead and do our boost here, right? Cook our meat. Now remember, we don't want to cook them all at once because there's a 4,000 XP max for things. Yeah. So we're going to try and do grilled rest. I can do those. Go for slurry. We'll cook these. Okay. So I'm going to cook half of these, right? Half of them, 85, gives us 2,200 XP. So, if you cooked maybe 100 of them at a time, because you would waste everything over 4,000, right? But, yeah, that was not bad at all. Get rid of that and that and no, not God damn it! Didn't mean to do that. Oh well, it's only 50 caps. Not like it was a rare thing anyways. And then what I do is I go in here and I just dump all the shit in this box because I don't use it. I don't need it. Get rid of that, get rid of those. God knows I got plenty of fucking money. So poached angler, stick those in there. And then, yeah. Yeah, that'll work. Okay. Pretty good run there. Yeah, pretty good run there. Kind of fucking insane. But good nonetheless. Now, did I do... Yeah, I did. Because I went from the... useless tech. Now, see, Clantry, if you're still watching, talking about the psychology of a camp, right? Where I told you guys, having a lot of one thing is not as good as having a little of a lot of things. This camp is a good example of that. You look at these categories going, what does this guy specialize in? Why would I want to go to this camp? What does he have that I'm going to want? He's got a one-star weapon, a one-star armor, just a couple of one-star, two-star weapons, okay? Two apparel, two armor. What are you selling, dude? Why would I go there? You got stim packs? You got a lot of stim packs, okay. You got a lot of meds. You could have some chems. Drinks? Who knows what that means? 12 plants? Not a lot. Two junk? Not a lot. So you probably don't have any script. Right? You probably don't have any of this. You probably don't have any of that. Probably don't have any of this. So this camp is not as attractive. This camp is not as attractive as someone who has a ton of shit in like five different categories. Because you know they've got a lot of stuff. Like this guy, Moon Daddy here, right? Tons of ammo, tons of weapons. Okay, good. Tons of fucking junk. Lots of reasons for people in those three categories to go to this fucking camp, right? It's an attractive camp. But it's psychology. You got to think like your shopper does. Your shopper's looking for something when they go to your camp. Very few people that I've ever seen just randomly browse. Okay, hey, Dag, you don't want to look, dude. This guy built up. But maybe he kept his machines on the ground. Let's see if he kept his machines on the ground. You keep your machines over here? No. Is it locked? No, it's open. Look at you. No, I'm not taking them. I've got plenty. Let somebody else be the beneficiary of that. Dear Lord. All right. Well, let's hope we don't fucking die. I put all my junk away, so even if I do die, who gives a shit? So what have we got here? Let's see what he's got. Let's see if I can figure out how to get up here. Up and up and up and up and up. Wish you could track our vendor sales. I am honestly astonished at this point we cannot. We have a new tab. You could add, you know, vendor sales in there. Oh, how fucking cute is this? Dude, this is awesome. Okay. I'm going to give Moondaddy9440 extra fucking props right now. Okay. Because if someone comes shopping and he crashes and this thing disappears, his vendor is in the monorail car, which means I'm not going to fall to my death if he crashes or logs out. Normally, when people build these cams in the air like this, they put the vendors floating in the air. So if they crash or log out, you're fucked. You fall right to your death, right? He has got his vendor inside a non-despawnable thing. So sure, I would lose access to the vendor, but I wouldn't die. Yeah? So bonus points, Jason, all script. Let's see if he's got a chainsaw in here. The dankest Graham joined the team. Rusty revolver. This is all scripts. Let's see if he's got a chainsaw in here. Is worth the piss. What was this? Oh, perfect storm. Oh, quad, but no. And see, this is a heartbreaker. Bullets explode, 15% reload speed, but it's fucking instigating. Medics. Two shot. Yeah, that 12,000. Yeah, 25 AP. That's a good price. 12,000 is a good price for that one. I don't know about those. Gauss rifle, gamma gun, Tesla rifle. He's got a good mix of script and a good mix of script and actual good hunter's urban scout. Nah, dude, script that. 2,000 for a bomber jacket? I mean, they're popular, certainly. And you could theoretically get that for somebody who was looking to burn caps or was in a hurry. Because they only come from one place. They only come in from turning in technical data. What have you got in here? Anything I want to get? Newsstand, hello, Neo sign. Yeah, nothing I want there. Ammo? You got some 5.56? I'll buy it all. Need to burn caps, man? Fuck yes, I will take it. Thank you very much. Most wanted? Zero people? Yeah, I figured that one. None of my dailies are popping in the mire here. Unfortunate. Oh, we got into the camp here. The dankest Graham. Again, see Glantry? This is what I'm talking about. A good section of armor, a good section of weapons, right? Which means 6 and 4 means they're probably really good, pretty good to really good, because he's selective about how many he puts in there, right? Got 164 plants, not too unusual. 14 apparel, another good mix, right? Not too few that you think he's good, doesn't have shit, but not so many that he's like, oh boy, look, a bunch of prisoner collars, right? This is the type of shit you want your camp to look like, yeah? Mine is a little bit over the king, but again, I specify in categories, right? My food is big, my chems are big, and my junk is big. My junk is big. But it's all about buyer psychology. You want to get the buyer to your camp. How do you do it? Well, you want the buyers who are going to buy the shit that you have for sale. Yeah, oh fuck, it's doing it again. There we go. I mean, over time, if you don't care about caps, you can just stock whenever, whatever, and just anybody who stops by, it's fine. But if you're looking to quote-unquote drum up sales, well, I guess it's in the pit. I guess it's in there. Because I don't see any doors here. Unless I missed one. Yeah, no. It's inside. I don't like going in fucking shelters, man. I don't like going in shelters. I wish that the icon on the map would tell me that the vendors are in the shelters. If they even know how to do that. But yeah, a sale log, dude, is something that is long fucking overdue. Okay? Especially considering the way the status message disappears. So sometimes you can't even tell. Yeah, see, look. It's got good weapons, right? Limb damage, not as good, but strength is good. Fixer? Vampire weapon speed, 15 grand? This is pretty much an 8K weapon. If it was 90 RW or faster reload, you'd have a winner. This is 8... AA and friggin' anti-armor and crit damage? 12,000? No. Yeah, that's a reasonable price. This is a good gun. I wish I had Henry on. I would buy that. Yeah, not unbad. Four Scout. You don't have any other stuff here, huh? Okay. What you got here? Decent. Decent prices here. Reasonable prices on the serums. Not out of line. This is a little bit steep. Brahmin plushie for assigned cage bulb lights for 1,000? Don't really, you know what? I want one of these. Cuckoo clock for 2,100? That's decent. Marine torso for 1,200? No. No. Okay, some of these are a little bit crazy. 5,000 for one minor fan? Yeah, it's about twice as much as it should be. That's why you're not selling it. But still, not terrible. Not terrible. Kind of a mixed bag on that one. Yeah, kind of a mixed bag on that one. I'm going to drop this here. It'll despawn pretty quick after I'm gone, so I'm not worried about leaving trash in this house. Your serums go for $299. Generally speaking, as long as they're below 500, they're a good deal. Yeah, as long as they're below 500. Because that's what they sell for at the vendor. That's what you sell them to a vendor for. And again, here you go, right? 10 weapons. But he's by the wayward, so it's like, okay, he could be selling script. It's hard to tell. $299. $350. My thing, I'll go for $350. Responders camp signal. God damn it, I was hoping that was going to be... Oh, this is cute. Caravan. But I don't know what he's trying to say here. It seems like there's a letter missing. UT. Oh, Caravan Outfitter. I see that it's an O. That's fucking cute. Wait a minute. How did he get the truck on that thing like that? Oh, that's fucking cool. Oh, that's fucking cool, dude. He put the Nuka truck over the back end of the busted fucking... How did you do that? Oh no, I don't want to build mode, dude. Okay, easy. No, because that ain't right. This is mobile home trailer. Oh, it says repair. So it's broken. He destroyed the RV. So it's the RV that's the soft one. He destroyed the RV and didn't repair. Yeah, because I was going to say, because this shit's all busted over here. And he's got a six-pack loot bag up here, some inert flux. That is fucking cool, dude. Tilius? Is that how you say it, dude? Tilius? If you and your friends are watching... He's got a, looks like he's got a mannequin, right? Mannequin underneath the thing there. This is fucking sweet, dude. This is fucking sweet. This is fucking sweet. Dude, you glitched the shit out of this place, man. He's sitting on the box. Look at that. Got a chair glitched on the box. Okay, we're going to go slow. Okay, I'm going to pan around slow. So y'all builders can see what he's doing here, and you can possibly screenshot anything you see of interest. Because there's a lot fucking going on here, okay? There is a lot going on here. And I'm just going to go slow so you can see it, okay? Natural clutter. Yeah, no, he's got stuff. Look at the backpack over there, dude. Like, the boxing gloves are above his head or her head. And then to the right, they got to keep my stuff. My stuff backpack, right? You know that's on a mannequin or on a thing, but I don't know where the fuck... I don't know where the hell the, I don't know where the hell... My God, how long did it fucking take you to do this, dude? Holy shit, this is amazing. I mean, they've got every fucking thing jammed in here, dude. Got the camp. Look at this. The camp module's inside the fucking the taxidermy workbench, which is also inside the weapon workbench, right? Because that's a weapon workbench back there, right? Isn't that a weapon workbench? Yeah, the weapon workbench is here, too. So you got the weapon workbench. You got the weapon. Yeah, the weapons workbench. And then the taxidermy station. Looks like there's a conduit here. You've got junk wall smash this fucking thing. Oh, look at this. Got the bottles on there. Dude, how the fucking long did it take you to do this? Holy shit, how long did it... Oh, I love the conduit keeping the fucking thing propped open so it doesn't fall. Oh, my God, dude. Oh, my God. Oh, and even better. You got punji boards on top of the thing. Oh, dude, this is tits, dude. This is fucking tits. Look at this thing. Oh my God, dude. Yeah, here's the flamethrower trap, right? So in case somebody fixes it, somebody helpful fixes it, he can just trigger it again. Got the fetch out here. We got, you know, some random crap back out here. Okay, no great shakes here. This is pretty doable. Shipping a bottle. Yeah, dude, they must have built this from the inside out. There's no fucking way you could have... There's no way you can maneuver the camera in there, right? This is insane, dude. This is so fucking awesome. Oh, man. This is so fucking awesome. Yeah, fuck this. I'm taking a picture of this. Let's turn that off and get rid of that. I can't even with this, dude. This is so fucking amazing. Oh. He even got shit up here on the sign. Dude, what the fuck? He's got the Brahmin grill up here, for Christ's sakes. Oh, dude, look at this shit. Even built up on the... Oh, no, these are conduits. How the fuck did he do that? It's straight conduits. Dude, look at this shit. This is... Oh, my God. Easy. This build is going to make you up your game. Yeah? This build is going to make you up your game, dude. Holy fuck, man. That's fucking impressive, dude. But it's so dense, dude. So much shit. There's the armor workbench with the weapon thing in it, right? And just layers and layers and layers of signs. And the little toys on the shelf. And the fucking stash box up here, dude. Oh my fucking God. And a base, so you can... I don't know why it would be in there. This is fucking amazing, dude. I can't even... Just this shot alone, dude. This shot alone is worth the price of admission. Makes me want to show you my micro build. Dude, if you could join me, I will just hook me up and tell me where you're fucking at. Ooh, look at this bad boy. 40K. No, these are showcase weapons. That's fine. Oh, man. Minix the Dragon. Good stuff. Mutant's Urban Scout. Good at camping them. Dude, I want to see it. It'll take him like a month to fucking do this, dude. I mean, how long does it take you? Because it's like every time you fuck it up, you basically have to start over, right? Because this game's building system is so fucking jank. That's why I'm looking at this going, how long did it fucking take you to do this, right? Because every time you did something wrong, you'd have to undo large portions of it to get it to work again. This is insane, dude. Yeah, Jim, if you want to pop in, dude, join the team. There's an open slot, or just, you know, let me know that you're here. And, go to my camp and buy, like, one thing so I know you're here. Because, of course, I'm an idiot. I forgot your username, but I'm sure if I see it again, it will remind me because I'm a ding-dong. This is fucking amazing, dude. More of this, please. Tilius. So, Tilius, whoever you are I keep saying it, but it's like, holy shit, this is exactly the type of shit I love. Yeah. This is the type of scrappy build that, yeah, dude, that's fucking awesome. Of course, it's really kind of a shitty thing that they put it there because a newbie's going to see it and think, oh my God, I could totally do this. I'm like, yeah, no, you can't. This is out of reach for you, my friend. in a big way. You stand no chance. You have no chance to survive. Make your time. Did we get a fucking thing to pop? We did not get a daily to pop. Man, I don't want to pop my. Well, I've been to Moonshine Jamboree like 30 times, so. I don't know, man. The camp's fucking awesome. But yeah, Jim, if you want to log in, dude, right now, I will be happy to do a brag section of the stream. It's Christmas. It'll be my present to you. Yeah, my present will be showing off your shit, and then you can tell the builders in here what you did and brag, which is fine with me too. Yeah, I'm all good. We're about the community, baby. We're about the community. I'm just a dude playing video games, and I love good builds. Although I will say this. If you want to do that, my friend, it better be good, because we got some good builders who will judge you. We have people who will say, "Oh, yeah, I guess it's okay for a beginner." So be ready, my friend. It's not all roses and ponies. Yeah, it can be a harsh mistress out here. Not really, but it's funny to think about. Let's go ahead and drop this fucker off. Okay, where's the dogs? There's one. And the other one's over there. Okay, nobody took the shovel, right? They didn't take the shovel. Perfect. Okay. Put you in there. Put you in here. And then drop the shovel. I drop it right here just in case somebody else does it behind me. I'm like, you know what? Here it is, dude. Purified water, disease cure, toxic valley, which is whatever. Okay, so we're gonna go here. I leveled again. 256. That's okay. No, I don't want that gun out. But even with fixing my chainsaw, even have a makeshift warrior on, dude. My chainsaw is 25% durability. I almost broke it, dude. Oh god, Moonshine Jamboree is so stupid, my friend. It's so stupid. It is so stupid. But goddamn, it's fun. Because it's stupid. Okay, what do we got? We got that. So we did some camp. We did some camp browsing, right? We looked at. Did we look at Dankusgram? Yeah, Dankusgram was the one with the big box and he had everything inside. Moon Days removed from the team? No, dude, they logged out like 20 minutes ago. What are you talking about? Silver in the Mire, you are here. Oh, and there you are. And see, okay, here's my thing. We talked about this last week. People who build in the Mire, in general, are more creative builders in the main. They just are. I don't know what it is about the Mire that inspires people who... Oh, fuck, it's nighttime. Shit. Okay, what have we got? Oh, this is tits. I'm liking it already, man. I'm liking it already. Did you build near a road? No, we're not near a road or nothing, are we? No, we're between the Excelsior model home and L.A. Ames' bunker, which is right... Oh! It's on top of the shelf. Ah, I did not know this was a thing. Let me see here. L. Ames' bunker is where? It's down here? Yeah, because this is where the... Okay, I know where we're at. I never even think to go up on top of that shelf. And we got, is this the butterflies? Yeah, it's the butterflies. Ooh, I like how you stacked the barbed wire fences. Curious how you did that. I'm going to guess it has something to do with skill because I don't have any. Power armor frame. Man, I wish these lights weren't so goddamn glaring, you know? This would be so much better if that light was like half the intensity, yeah? Oh man, look at this. Look at this shelf. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. We got a floating toaster. Uh-oh. Oh, didn't quite get the alignment right. Yeah, I'm gonna bust your balls. And I know you probably hate it, so whatever. It's fine. Yeah, but this is cool, dude. This is fucking sweet. Nice turret placement right there. I'm curious how the hell you got that thing in there, but not curious enough to want to find out how to actually do it. And then we've got, yeah. See, this thing, this shelf stacking stuff, I know how it works. I don't have nearly the... How the fuck did you get that light on that conduit like that, dude? I want to know how you did that. because I know those lights only snap the ceilings, man, and they drive me crazy. I love this kind of hanging light arch. This is fucking cool. This is cool. Tiny little plant field here. I have no idea how you got these so close together, but I know it's possible. Yeah, knowing a thing is possible, knowing how to do it, two different things. I love this light. This hanging thing, dude. I know, it's this type of shit, right, that it's like, oh shit, eviction notice, dude. Fucking eviction notice. Oh my god, eviction notice just popped, dude. Oh shit. Silver, team up, dude. Let's go murder some shit. Let's go get this done, dude. I'll come back to this. I can't pass up an eviction notice, dude. Don't log out till we're done. I'm going to get so many goddamn legendaries, I'm never going to store them all, dude.
Is anyone out there?
This recording is a call for help. Okay, down the chain link fence line. Don't forget. Down the chain link fence line. Do not go towards the thing. Okay, Silver, can you run the train, dude? Are you able to solo this shit? Because if you are, dude, we can just start right now. Get my Chinese stealth on. Get my rad shield on. And it's motherfucking party time, dude. If you can keep that downhill slope clear, I can get the uphill slope. Got you. Go. Go ahead and start her up, dude. We'll light these fuckers up. Because, I mean, people don't only care if you can't hold it until they can get there, right? But if you could, we can hold it down, man. I mean, I keep that scrubber running. I can definitely hold down the scrubber from the uphill shit. All right, I'm on bag duty. There's one up there. Of course you've got a railway. Okay, here we go. There's that one. Looks like we got some visitors. Guess we're gonna have to murder these guys real quick. Okay. I'll go ahead and get the bag on top here, if there's one on top. Yeah, here it is. All right, I'm on the scrubber, homie. Work your magic. Keep those legendaries. Ah, goddammit. Keep those guys in the downslope from getting up my ass. That's all I'm asking, man. That's all I'm asking. Keep these assholes from getting up my ass. I can hold the scrubber. Okay. Anybody coming from downhill? AK Reaper's doing it. Oh, yeah. We got some people coming. All right. Cool. Let me get rid of this shit right now. I don't need those clogging up my fucking sight lines. But yeah, man, we're doing it. Well, we're going back. Don't worry. We're after this event. We're going back up there. We're going to check out his fucking camp. AK Reaper's up there. We got Silver's over there. Okay, cool. Dankus Graham's up. Oh, yeah, dude. This is going to be a cakewalk, man. Unless we get some guys breaking bad from the fucking town, this is going to be a fucking nice, nice, sleepy, fucking easy peasy lemon squeezy. Come on, you son of a bitch. We got it. It's all about support, ladies and gentlemen. If all these guys doing their DPS don't have to worry about the event failing, they don't ever have to take their eyes off the prize, and that's what we're after. Yeah, look at this. We're getting all kinds of crew coming up now. Do I still have it going? Yeah, I got 22 minutes. This is going to be awesome, dude. This is going to be an easy one, man. Useless tech. All right, useless tech down there. We got Banana Monkey up here. We got Zombie Taco. We got the Dinkus Graham. Yeah, this is going to be... And everybody's over... I'm the lowest level out here, dude. I'm 256. No, wait a minute. Never mind. Banana Monkey's 148. He's running around with Whacker Smacker, so it's like, yeah. Yeah, this is going to be... I could probably AFK this. I could probably AFK this, man. You got it, man. You go up to the spawns and beat things up, man. I've got this. I've got the scrubber. We are good. I have my hat and I have my fixer, man. Yep. And they're... Are they taking care of that? Yeah, there's no chance, dude. Useless tech rocking the gold, what the fuck is that, XO1? Is that XO1? Oh god, dude, this is sick. I'm not even using any bullets here, man. This is about as pretty as it gets, my friends. And Silver's out there soloing the whole goddamn downside spawn, so I'm down with that. I should get closer so I can get some free XP, yeah. Just get over here and hang out, it's like it's a free XP, yeah? I keep an eye on the scrubber, the guy's got the uphills done. I thought you went down, but you're up, so we're good. Oh fuck, I'm gonna stay here then, man. I'm just gonna go ahead and leech off the free XP. Oh man, 814? Oh fuck, I'm staying over here for sure. I was joking, but man, holy shit. 814? Yeah, baby, we're gonna do this. Cause I can see the scrubber, man, just fine. And if it breaks, I can get back to it really easy. Well shit, we have a new strategy then. I've never had a, you know what, I'll just donate a lunchbox because why not? Yeah, why not? I've got 40 of them. Let everybody else cash in a UFO above this place. You can't build too close to it. It's restricted area, right? The closest you can build is right down there by the trees and then right up over the crest of the hill. Yeah, that's the only place you can really build here. And they do. I see, you know, turret camps and shit. This is a fucking... This is sick, dude. I'm like... Well, I guess we didn't have to worry, Jim. We didn't have to run this train for very long by ourselves. Turns out the lure of a double XP weekend will get people out here. Yeah, this is... Okay, you know what? I'll lose the legendaries from over there and from up there, but dude, the XP, man. Dude, you're giving me 800 XP per team kill here. What the fuck is even up with that? That's the crazy shit, babies! Oh, this is gonna be the easiest goddamn eviction notice I think I've done in my life. I mean, dude, how many people are here? Just out of curiosity. 9. Yeah? 9. We got 9 here. Let me tag these guys, get some XP out of them. Jesus Christ, Silver, what the fuck are you... Oh, you, well, you're bloodied, of course. And of course, that railway is probably, that railway is probably a G-roll. Because these guys are pretty tanky, so watching you erase them as fast as you are is, wow, look at all the legendaries down here. What? No wonder you guys camp up here. Holy Christ, dude. I thought there was only the 3 that spawned there, but it was like 4 of them over there. What are you doing? Sit down. Yeah, the scrubber's been barely even touched, man. This is nuts, dude. I mean, hilarious, but nuts. There's nothing you need to shoot here. There you go, up on the rail, very good. Man, fuck you, dude. Where is he? I want that fire starter dead. Yeah, let's get you. Oh, look, I leveled again. Yay, go me. Mostly off of leeched XP at this point. All right, I'm gonna go defend the rat scrubber, dude. See if you can manage up there without me. Oh, Christ Almighty, dude. One bad hit and that scrubber's going down, so I gotta do my job first. XP good, scrubber bore. Scrubber better. Well, all it takes is gonna take one stray grenade, man. That'll do it. So, we're gonna wait. And there ain't nobody near it, so... I have to prioritize, yeah? Okay. gonna get loose. And like I predicted, it went down and now it's back. No, I got it, man. We got it, fam. You're good. Don't worry. Scrubbing duty is what I live for, my friend. Ah, Silver, you get bushwhacked by a fire starter? It don't take much, does it? God, these guys got a ton of fucking health, though. Come on, die, dude. Why is he not dying? Jesus Christ. Oh, there's a fire starter. He got loose. Okay. We're good. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. No, 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 no. Slow down. Slow down. Slow down. Slow down. And no, you gotta move. Boom. I'm on it. We got it. I got plenty of health. We're good. There it goes. Fuck you, dude. This is my house. You get no fire starter. I'm gonna die. No, I didn't die. Look at that. And I leveled again, so I got my, I'm so kind of exciting at the end here. Must have had some unfortunate fatalities or people moved out of position briefly. Yes, yeah, so we fixed the scrubber twice, yeah? Not bad. That's how we roll, babies. That's what's up, ladies and gentlemen. Love. That's how we do it. So I got, what, 2 levels there? 2.5? 3 levels there? I don't even know, dude. Yeah, I'm going down here, because I know there's a bunch of legendaries back over here. Good God. Oh yeah, she's going to be done for a month, dude. Holy shit. 3? I got 3? Okay. Wasn't even paying attention. The only reason I really care about leveling at events like this is because when I level, yeah, I get my health back. Troubleshooters Union left leg. I sure wish they fixed that. What is it? Cryo and sweet spot? Well, it was a piece of shit anyway, so good. I had to piss. So yeah, we're 259. 259. And we started the day at... I want to say maybe 245. I guess I have to look back at the start of the stream. So we got, what, 14 levels today. Just fucking around, doing random events. Of course, we did get a couple of Moonshine Jamborees, which... when Moonshine Jamboree comes up, man, between the kills and the fucking XP you get from the meat, you're just like, alright. Thank you very much, Gem Silver. I don't know, I'm going to call you Gem because that's your name here. Thank you very much for you just running this fucking train. Holy shit. Holy shit. Unyielding Botsmith. That's what I don't want to see, man. Because I can't trade Botsmith armor, you fuckers. I need to trade the armor. Okay. Well, hey, I can still move, though. That's kind of nice. Didn't really expect that to be happening. I thought I'd be walking by now. Is the magazine up? It is not up. All right. Let's get her changed. Let's change back into this. Get my other gun back out. Okay. All right. Get the right gun back out, and then we do. No. We're just gonna change our this and this. I wasn't even wearing my 3-inch Under Armour there either. All right. Time to scrap. I'm just going to dump a bunch of these legendaries, I think, because, I mean, what am I going to do with them? I'm going to have a mutated event in 6 minutes, but I'm not going to worry about that. I want to go see Silver's Gem's camp here. I'm going to go back there. Once I scrap all this fucking steel. That was a good eviction news, though. I hope these guys cashed in. I hope the people who came later on got sufficient XP for their time. Of course, we pop lunch boxes, and that helps, too. Keep those things running all weekend long, man. Ain't no joke. Because everybody got a free one today, so... 429? Okay, do I have enough room in my stash for this shit? We got 100 pounds. Gotta get rid of this shit. 35, 45. Put those in there, and then for weapons, debilitator 16. I only got his 5 pounds left, but I'm at 287, so I can move again. Yeah, I can move again. And that's my other fixer. Okay. Right. Okay. So got that done. I'm all awake again, but whatever. And let's go ahead and do Silver's Camp. Let's finish our tour. Let's finish our tour, because in about 5 minutes we're gonna get one more mutated event, and we're gonna call this shit. But that's how crazy these weekends get. And that's why she. Hold on a second. And this is why she's level 259 after less than a month. Less than a month. I love these lights on this conduit. After less than a month of play, she's literally eight levels a day. Well, this is cute. Got all this stuff backed in here. Man, how long did it take you to do this, man? All this crap smashed in here. Little stairway up here going to this. Man, you've got the works. You've got these things really smashed in here. I like this, though. I like this a lot. Man, there's a lot going on here, isn't there? You got the windmill through some metal house pieces, which has also got sunk with this stash cabinet here. And then the shelves and the stuff crammed in here. God, how long did it take you to do this, man? This is, I can't close the lid, huh? What is this? Well, it's dripping. Some kind of something. Let me see here. Let's peruse your wares here. See what you've got for sale. Yeah, that's a good one. That's a really good one. 10 grand for this? Maybe. Maybe. Field scribe for 2k? You can go ahead and script that thing, dude. Canned coffee? 2000? Okay. Good price on the plans. Yeah. So why do you have 6 for 40 and only 2 for 10? Those are the ones you want to sell, I guess? And the rest is just a flex? I'm gonna buy this from you. I don't care, they're 5 caps apiece, dude. Okay, let's go back to the tour. Let's go back to the tour. So let's jump up here and take a look. Let's see if we can. Well, are there stairs back there? No, that's the roof. Okay, so there's something underneath here. Holy shit. Okay. Yeah, this is kind of dense, dude. This is, you don't remember. That's fair, man. That's fair. I like the bed on top of the cabinet. This is fucking cool. Big fan of doing beds on tables and dart machines smashed in behind a wall. You could probably play it, but you can't really see it. Sink inside the chem bench. Another cabinet under here. You like using them cabinets for supports, man. Of course, it's, you know, makes sense because they're all the same height, so you can make the appearance consistent. Yeah. Got her stuffed in here with a bunch of shit to interact with, so that's pretty good. Display case backwards, it's a pain in the ass. Space, yeah, man, this place is just stuffed floor to ceiling. God, how long did it fucking take you to do this, dude?
Pardon me.
How long did it take you to do this, dude? Holy shit. Just the amount of fine-tuned movement you would need to get this crap in here like this. Is berserk, dude. You got the rat stag here? No, that's. So wait a minute. This is not. This half pig is. On another conduit. So you've mastered however you learn to hang things on conduits. You have mastered that part, because now that I know what I'm looking at, I'm seeing them everywhere. Yeah. Then over here, yeah, this is the stack. More market stuff, and This is very snug, dude. Very snug. Okay, I hear it, but I don't see it. Here it is. Let me take that real quick because I'm a full health build. Oh, it's guided meditation. Let it be active camouflage. let's do this. You put in weapon artisan. Okay, where's your weapon workbench? Here? That's armor. Now the fun part. I need to find your weapon workbench. I need to find it right fucking now because I gotta get up there. I need the weapon workbench upstairs. I gotta fix this chainsaw. Is it here? Let's tinker. Here it is, right here. Modify repair. Come on, come on, come on, come on, hurry up. I gotta fix my... Gotta fix this. Yeah, there we go. Perfect. Thank you, sir. All right. Not gunsmith. Makeshift warrior. Okay. Bitches, the side is mine. You guys go wherever you want. That was a fucking nice build, dude. Thank you for logging in and letting us experience it and letting me go around like some goddamn tourist, like I've never seen a camp build before in my life. I'm like, no, man, that was fucking awesome. That was absolutely fucking awesome. Okay. Run this bad boy. And then in here, do we get a... We didn't get it. Okay. So anybody... Okay, so they got you. Who's this? We got somebody else here. Can't see the names or the thing, but that's okay. This is my house right here. This is where I stay. Motherfuckers. Now we're going to wait. Yeah? We're going to wait. Da-da-da-da-da-da. What we were just looking at? No, Glantry, that was gems. That was silvers. That was silver's micro build. He's like, I got a micro build. I'm going to fucking log in, dude. Log in and tell me where it is. We'll go tour it. I'll make you famous or something. Pose for my scope. Okay. That's an interesting name. Okay, my sound just really crapped out here. All right. 417, let's see if anybody else shows up here. That would prove holy, yeah. I tried to go through it slow so you all could screenshot stuff. Yeah. Okay, we got four here now? Okay. Tilius just showed up. Tilius, how you doing, boss? You've got a massively good camp, my friend. Massively good camp. Yeah, what the fuck? We just use one, so I'm going to use another. Hell, I got them. Might as well. Let's use a scout banner or two, too. I got two of those. Yeah. I got a ton of scout banners, and they don't go with me when I...
Pleasant greetings.
Please gather at the Tranquility Sanctum for today's guided meditation. Taking you on a spiritual journey toward transcendence. We will begin shortly. Take a moment to appreciate your surroundings, and remember... Your generous enrollment donations make this spiritual journey possible. Are you ready?
Are you ready?
Close your eyes. Take a deep breath. Inhale. 2, 3. Hold. 2, 3. Exhale. 2, 3. Okay, Bjork? If you get up here on the right-hand side, and we both hold our chainsaws like this, nothing will get through here, dude. We will be a flaming meat grinder. Just saying. Just saying. If you stay on the other side, yeah, just like that. If you move right there. No, you almost did it. Dude, if we do this, we're a meat grinder. Yeah. This is how we will attain transcendence. Oh, good. So the Dankusgram's over there with the Tesla. That's why it's so slow here. Good. That'll work. That will absolutely fucking work.
As you build your pillars of transcendence,
you may find yourself surrounded by discordant forces that seek to hinder your spiritual enlightenment. Banish them.
Banish them using whatever positive affirmations you wish.
And do not let them tear down your pillars. Yeah. I'm not reading subtitles, guys. I'm not reading the subtitles, man.
And any other negativity.
Okay, Bjork knows I've got this under control. With Dankusgram out there with the fucking Tesla, there ain't shit getting by here, so we're good.
Sometimes,
and see, this is why I like the events, man. Because if you can figure out what other people are doing and how good they are doing what they're doing, you can sort of figure out where you can slot yourself in there to be effective and slot yourself in to be effective without stepping on anybody's toes. And you turn this well-oiled machine. It's kind of nice. So yeah, like Bjork figured out there was nothing here, right?
Now that you have everything visualized, I will begin a series.
He saw Dankusgram over there covering that side, right? So if anything gets by Dankusgram, I'm gonna get it here, and Bjork's like, well, fuck it, I'm gonna go where there's more shit to kill. So then what you do is you watch to see which speakers are going down, and you know that's where the traffic is, right? Because nobody's killing them. You're like, all right, that's where the meat is. I'm going to go there. The bridge goes down because it's a pain in the ass to defend. But, yeah, we're doing it. And there goes the interior, right? So now I'm going to potentially get some company. But I might not. Because if I do, they're going to come from the interior down to the right-hand side. But generally, the interior ones will go to the courtyard next if the courtyard's up. So, we will stand here and patrol. And make Groucho's favorite meat street piles here.
You. Embrace it.
Daniel Cho, how you doing, buddy?
Into your pillars and allow it to lead you.
If you want
to
take a nap and go AFK, dude, you're more than welcome.
Transcendental bliss.
How many people are here? 11. Yeah, this is going to be a fucking cakewalk. Anything more than four in this thing is you can just basically AFK it. You can sleep through it, be drunk and stoned and whatever. Delicatessen, that's what I'm talking about. You want fresh meat? Yeah, we got it right here. Freshly cut. I even seasoned it, sauteed it for you a little bit. Did a little cauterizing for you, man. And see, I see the bridge needs to go down, right? I'm like, oh, go get him, Daniel. You got it. I got this, dude. There's lots more XP somewhere else. Delicatessen of death. Yeah, the deli of death. Well, you know, meat is murder, but that's okay. When you're hungry enough, that looks pretty fucking tasty. Speaking of hungry, my stomach just growled, so it must be getting close. Oh, that's right. Top of the hour, so it's 3 o'clock. All right. And look at this, man. This is the best way to run an event, in my opinion, right? To be fucking bored. Yeah? This is my favorite. We're going to... Dude, what did you drop a flare for? Excuse me. He just walks up, drops a flare, then runs away. And I'm like, what are you doing, dude? What are you doing, man? Okay. Interior requires repair. Who's in the interior? There's four people up there, man. Come on, fix that shit. And it's kind of late for the party, but it's better than late than never, right? I love fucking chainsaw. If I ever run a melee build, it's going to be a chainsaw build. I'm 100%. I don't know if I'm going to do it. I don't know if...
warm, relaxing energy.
Someone was asking about chainsaw builds, and I don't know about chainsaw builds. I don't know how the game treats them as weapons. I mean, does strength actually help you with chainsaws?
Because,
I mean, it wouldn't seem like it did because it's a chainsaw, right? The blade...
brings with it a wave of tranquility and deep relaxation.
I mean, the blade's doing the work, so what perks would you need for a chainsaw build? I guess I could just look it up online. I'm sure Angry Turtle's done something on it, right? But yeah, if I ever switch to melee, dude, it's going to be a chainsaw. This thing is fucking fun. Of course, it's only really fun once you get dual blade and flaming, right? You got to get dual blade, man. That's where the damage comes out. And then I would have to get the various various things in intelligence to keep my weapon from breaking. I would need I don't even know what perks apply.
The lens of your mind's eye. See yourself as others.
I really don't even know how this works. I mean, it's so effective without any perks at all, other than the perk to keep it from breaking so fast. But then again, Moonshine Jamboree was getting some heavy use, yeah. It was getting some heavy use at Moonshine Jamboree. I think I held the trigger down for 8 straight minutes, man. So it's like, yeah, that's going to wear your weapon out. You're going to wear out your tool if you keep beating on it for 8 minutes straight. Badum tish. Yeah, the sound got... Well, I guess the sound on the thing is still good. I don't know. 43 seconds, and look at that. The side meditation is the only one that is full health and has never gone down. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. This is my house. Keep your ass back,
only
bitch.
Through complete transcendence will you attain true enlightenment.
And this is why I want ghoul slayers, right? Because the places I use it most are guided meditation and radiation rumble. And that's all ghouls. Yeah? So if I can erase them even faster, it's better. Yeah? 14 seconds. Look at that. We're going to do it. We didn't kill hardly anything this time. I'm kind of disappointed by the limited piles of meat at our feet. It's street meat at our feet. Yeah, look at that shit. All right. Perfection. Did we get our mutated party pack? We better have. Oh, look, some stragglers. Where are you going, bub? Nowhere, mon frere. Mutated party pack. Hell yeah, baby. We got the meat. We're all good. Switch back to gunsmith. Switch back to my gun. And go see if there's any stray loot I can get. Because he was killing shit pretty close to me, so maybe I get lucky there'll be... No, nobody... There goes with the fucking flares again. What is he even doing with those flares, dude? I don't even know. All right. Let's go inside. See if we get any... Now, see, the thing is, the Scorched in here can spawn the Holiday Scorched. So if we get lucky, one of these will be a Holiday Scorched because they're legendaries, right? Since we just did an event, right? If any of them are down here and got killed, we can loot them. All right, so we're going to break this up. We're going to go through here, and we're going to see if we can't get any... my footsteps are completely not sounding. So the sound cut out on this thing in a bad way. Don't forget the lead here. There's a bunch of lead in here. Some good shit right there. Yeah. Okay, so there we go. Oh, caps. I never turned the light on in here. Yeah, these guys all dead. And then up here, the sugar bombs. There they are. All right, some plastic. That means we're going to get my spices up here and my sugar. Spices, sugar, and we're going to get some salt and pepper in here because there's pepper. There's one right there, but we don't get him because he must have died before we got here. Son of a bitch. There's pepper here, and then there's salt back over here. And another flare just went off. I don't know why that's so funny, but it is. He has a flare for the dramatic. Yes. Yes. He has more flare. He needs more flare. So we didn't get... He must have died before the event started. That's fine. Whatever. Oh, but this guy... Ha ha ha! This guy did not. Always check. After a guided meditation during holiday scores, always check. Make sure that there isn't one down there that you can just totally gank. Yes, Mole Flare. I can't take you people anywhere. All right, so what we're going to do is we're pretty much done for the day, I think. So I'm going to go back over here. I'm going to log out on a good camp, not on my camp. The Dankest Graham left the team. That's fine, dude. You good. Okay, let's do this. Oh, it's sunny outside. Good. There's some sun shining through. Perfect. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to go here, turn off depth of field, and go up. Da 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 da. Ah, god damn it. No, the sun's not going over far enough. Man, I wish you could do... I mean, that's the one thing No Man's Sky did that That's the one thing No Man's Sky did that was really cool, is you could move the sun to get better lighting. I'm taking a picture of this, man. Okay, that's the whole camp right there, guys. That's it. That's the entire fucking thing. And right about there. All right. Immortalized. Immortalized. And with that, let's see. Where's a good place to stand over here? If I do it like this, get the camera in the background, I can't see a goddamn thing. Now we'll stand sideways. Do it this way, yeah? There we go. So that's what a good camp looks like, guys. You're not going to see me build one of these, but at least I can show you other people's good camps, yeah? So there's something. So with that, I want to thank y'all for stopping by and sharing your pre-Christmas Eve Sunday with me for the up to 3 hours and change that you did, if you did. If you had a good time today, I hope you had a good time today. This is kind of a weird stream, kind of all over the place, but it was kind of fun, I think. If you had a good time today, I appreciate you clicking that like button. Feed that YouTube algorithm. Make them regret putting fucking interstitials in my goddamn mid-roll ads in my streams. I wish I could turn that crap off. Anyway, if you're new to the channel and this is the first thing you're seeing and you like this kind of thing, click subscribe for more of this kind of thing. I stream something on Sunday starting at noon central. Currently, Fallout 76 might be something different in the future. But for now, we're going to hang out with this one here. I want to say happy holidays, Merry Christmas, and all the various well wishes statements to everyone and sundry in the chat. I hope it's nice and quiet and drama free. And if you're that kind of person, profitable. Who's popping up fucking flares? Okay, what the hell, dude? You guys chased me around and putting popping up flares. As always and as ever, I want to thank y'all for watching. Be safe, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care, y'all.